and gentlemen of the World Wide Web, how are you doing today? I gotta duck under this thing.
Oh,
here we go. Fascinating. How gimpish I looked.
Oh, I wish y'all could have seen that. That was great.
That was actually amazing.
That was like, that was as flexible as I could be right there. That was just as flexible as I could be. Welcome to another episode of... I stopped breathing so heavy. Welcome to another episode of Candid Conversations. Oh, gosh. That wasn't even that. That is such a mint angle. I think that's the best angle we've got of any show that we've done so far.
Yeah, it's a dope angle.
Too bad I just had to look like a monkey jumping out of a rhino's ass to get to it.
Bruh.
Did you take your shot?
Oh, my goodness. I didn't even take my shot. Now I gotta go back.
Oh, no.
Now you gotta go back.
Now I gotta go back, bro. Now this time I gotta duck.
One more time.
Oh.
Oh, we're wavy.
Bam.
We're wavy.
We're wavy. Okay. Okay. This good? Is good.
You good, bro?
I'm good. I'm good. We're going to do this again, though. All
right.
We're going to do this again,
you can,
though.
You can fit through there.
I know.
I believe in you.
I got to think small. I got to think small. There we go. Oh, this is how I made it through the first time.
There you go, bro.
There we go. What up, Chris? What up, Audrey? Hello, cousin. What up, Don? I was Don Moncor. Cheers. It's another episode. The 20th episode. Cheers.
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 All right.
All right.
One shot, one kill. What's the deal?
Cool.
Nah, that's two shots. Forget that nonsense.
Almost.
Ah, start. That one's for you, bro. Ha. Bitter.
And that right there is why I don't drink tequila.
I don't blame you, but... Since I'm going to
not
be home,
a single part of that looked enjoyable for you.
The after warmth. Excellent. Sorry I'm so out of breath, ladies and gentlemen. I had to do some yoga flame moves to get from behind the control center.
That's one way
not
to put it.
Not flexible at all.
No, I'm not. I used to be. I used to be very flexible. I could do the whole Wii Fit plus...
Did you say Wii Fit?
Yo, listen.
Like, listen. as in, you based your athletic ability off the video game?
Listen, hold on a second.
Hold on, wait, no. Can we stop right there?
I used to do the whole workout regimen, like both yoga and the strength exercises. Do the whole thing.
And you know what, bro? I've been playing Red Dead lately, and I'm just like a professional fucking cowboy, man. I'm telling you, man, I can fucking ride a horse like a motherfucker.
It's not my fault.
I can jump the motherfuckers. I can...
So you don't believe in VR training then?
Oh, that's stuff.
Not Nintendo doing it, bro.
What do you mean not Nintendo doing it? Where do you think they get some of the software, bruh?
Are you really gonna sit here and say that Wii Fit is a good way of gauging your physical attributes?
It's a good way of monitoring your physical capacity. That's what I'm saying. Like he's holding something in. I'm not saying it's the be all and end all of athleticism and athleticism and activity. I'm just saying for someone who doesn't find themselves engaging in society as often or doesn't find themselves to
fitness level.
Yeah, their fitness level might not be comfortable in like, you know, public like conduct gym. in the public gym or a public forum like
play
that.
Play Nintendo.
Listen.
No, you're spitting my words at like you're a DJ, bro.
Play Nintendo.
Speaking of which, shout out to DJ Stretch, who's going to be spitting at the pop-up party next Wednesday at Borderline, 607 King Street in Welland. Yeah. We also going to have, like, we're going to have Green Tree Records out there. We going to have, I believe, Tino's coming through as well to perform. Zach Burry's going to be on the card. We have Tori Cook. We got Greg Bonito Comedy coming through. Who else?
Whoever you don't remember is going to be really pissed if they watch this.
That's what I'm saying. Who else? That's what I'm trying to figure out who else. But I think... No. No, I think I got everybody.
You got everybody?
Yeah, I got everybody.
Well
yeah.
Done.
Yeah. Thank you. All right. So who's brought topics to the table today? What's grinding your gears, or what's enlightened you? What's brought you to a better state of life, so to speak?
We.
No doubt.
So I think that's the end of that conversation.
That's what's up. That's what's up. You know what I mean? You ain't got to go into a long, drawn-out statement. It's like weed.
Just weed.
That's it. That's
oh, hey. It's, all right. Let's talk about, obviously, fucking election that just happened.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about that. Okay. Like, I didn't vote for Trudeau because, I mean.
Asshat.
Yeah, it's kind of dank. Yeah. But I definitely am better. You know, I'm happy with the result compared to the alternative.
Tell me that you didn't vote for Scheer.
Bruh. Do I look like somebody who fucking vote for the conservative fucking party?
I'm just saying. I'm just making sure, bro.
Sing all
I'm
the just, way, bro.
Okay, okay. Okay.
Fuck that.
I think, honestly, I don't
know. I am farther left than the NDP is, bro. I only vote NDP because that's, like, the most left that I can get.
Well, the Green Party.
I'm just going to put
this
out there.
Yeah, but they get, like, 8 votes in this area, so they... voting for them is just thrown away.
I'm just going to put this out there. I think the Bloc got so many votes because of piggybacking off of my name. Just saying.
Bro!
Just saying.
You are not connecting your name to Bloc a political party that has been a separatist movement for like 20, 30 years.
30 years? They've been the separatist movement since they've been, bro.
So you're saying that they've been the Bloc since before you were the Bloc?
Oh, well, I wouldn't say
maybe
that.
Were you influenced by them, bro?
No,
did you watch some news shit growing up and you were like, the
See,
Bloc?
How
I like
to
that.
Flip my words and shit,
I like that
and gentlemen.
Shit. I'm gonna take that. So maybe are you influenced by the Bloc de Quebecois?
No, I was probably more.
Is that why you're
by
such
by
a separatist from society and want things your own way?
I'm a separatist from society because society can't manage my mentality
Ooh.
And my mass at the same time.
Both Blocs, they
you
just want
I mean?
To separate.
They're not prepared for someone like of my stature and capacity to function in my true like ability.
That's like what Quebec says.
No, Quebec says we don't want to do what you are doing. We are going to separate, but we want to keep your money. Ah, import and export. Ah, that's I don't give a fuck. That's what y'all sound to me
bruh.
Right now. Like, well, sorry, like,
bruh,
it is bruh. What it is. It is what it is. I'm
did you really just have to throw in that? What is this fucking Beauty and the Beast shit?
Oh my goodness, where's the carrots and broccoli? Oh.
Apparently all French people sound like Disney characters.
Oh my gosh, I did not say that at all, but
Jesus Christ.
Victoria Thomas says,
yeah!
Looking good, Miss May. Mr. Jones, honestly, I have to say this right now.
What did she say?
Looking good, Miss May.
Oh, hey, Tori.
All right.
Thanks for coming on here.
Yes, I appreciate your presence in our lobby. Give it some time. More people should join. We're going to try and keep it interesting. David Jones, by the way, he is a wizard, I'm going to say that, with graphics. You know what I mean? I was talking about the show that we have next week at Borderline, 607 East Main Street. Not East Main Street. 607 King Street. Sorry, got that wrong. 607 King Street is where Borderline is located. And we're going to be having an event there called a pop-up party. It was called the Halloween Edition or Halloween Pop-up Party. It's hosted by Expose the North. And it's going to be a costume optional shindig where everybody can come through, you know what I mean? Hear some good music, vibe out with the artists, and listen to some tunes, support your local artists, etc. I think it's going to be fun, and that's not just because I'm hosting the event.
Is it a Halloween event?
It's a Halloween event, yes. So
will there be a Halloween costume party?
There will be a costume party, and there will be a prize awarded for the best costume.
Ooh, I better ask.
Yes. Yes. So there's going to be, it's going to be an interesting event, to say the least. But don't just take my word for it. Come out and contribute your awesomeness to the event. And, you know what I mean? Like, let's start getting the scene going, like, building up the scene going on out here. It's not just, like, it's one thing for a promoter to put an event together, but the event is really nothing unless the public goes out to that thing. So.
Of course, yeah.
Well, that's facts. It couldn't be, like, that's 100% facts.
And, like, what? Here's my thing. I'm still trying to figure out what it is that people want to see. That's one of
their own friends.
Okay, maybe I should have asked that question out loud. Hold on, we got another comment. Yes, Jones. So, yeah, if you're in the chat room, David Jones, and link him for graphic design, social media marketing as well. We do have a multimedia, social media, a media guru in here as well. Yeah, right here.
So I know it wasn't me because I'm horrible with that shit.
Bro, honestly, people are taking notice of your cover, the covers that you're making.
Oh, that one
no.
That I...
Yeah.
Did you share the one that I made you? With the you pouring out the drink?
Yes, you did. That one was dynamite. Same. That was dynamite.
Glad I could help.
Sitting here like, no, my cup had a cameo. But it was all good, you know what I mean?
You want an extra percent on the royalties there, Block?
If it's available, I'll take it. Yep. I'm not going to deny an extra percent.
All right, Block.
I'm not going to...
You're up to 3% on that track.
I'm not going to fight over... You see, I get 3%. You know what 3% is? Better than 0%. You know what I mean? I got people fighting me over 10%. She's like, wait a minute. I'm doing 90% of the work and you want 30% of the royalties?
Bruh.
Like, that's not how it works.
Capitalism.
I ain't even gonna say, oh man, even that word.
Capitalism, bro.
I knew that was gonna come up at some point.
Yeah, yeah.
It was a scourge of society.
We should have made it a drinking game.
Yeah, every time he says
bro, if y'all gonna drink every time I say capitalism, bring a big fucking bottle.
Oh my goodness.
I brought a bottle.
Oh, she showed me up. She finished the whole thing. Alright, fine. But she said she got less than I did, so that's alright.
No, I did it in 2 shots.
Oh, okay.
I won't lie.
All right, cool. Cool. I appreciate your honesty.
Always honest.
Who you got checking in here now? Seth Reeker. What up, Seth? How you doing? Raptors all the way. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Last night.
I had to bring out my Raptors red. Let's talk about that, huh?
You over there looking at me because you can finally say you cheer for a team that won something.
A winning team. A internationally competitive winning team. And I said the Raptors were going to be that team.
Who was the MVP last year of that season?
Okay, it was Kawhi Leonard who destroyed Anthony Davis last...
Where is he now?
He's gone, but he destroyed Anthony Davis and LeBron. So, you know what I mean?
Where is he now?
But he played with us last year. So that means we know how he plays fresh. We fresh know how he plays. So he has to change up his whole shit when he plays Toronto. He has to change up his whole, like, say he had a curry shit before, he has to have, like, a fucking, like, a jerk chicken shit now. You know what I mean? He has to have a jerk shit now. He can't come up here with the same shit.
He's y'all's LeBron.
No doubt.
Came in, worked magic, then said, I bet.
No doubt. But he worked his magic.
I just have to say something.
Okay.
Let's talk about this.
Let's talk about it.
So yesterday, I streamed the game.
Yeah.
Because now... It's not free anymore. So tying capitalism into basketball.
Oh, boy.
What the fuck? And it literally cut out like 6 or 7 times. How is that not a public service that we used to have growing up? We used to be able to watch any game, anytime, right?
Yep.
Now we can't.
Because people used to play it because they actually liked the sport. Now they play it for fucking big-ass paychecks. You look back at sports in the 50s and 60s, especially the hockey players and shit like that. Like, Rocket Richard, one of the greatest hockey players of all time,
ever.
Worked in a fucking steel mill or some shit. Like, worked in a factory day job.
Yep.
Like, that was back when the sports were just given to you, basically, by people who liked the sport. Now it's been co-opted by Coca-Cola and
marketing,
Pepsi.
Like, teams that...
Nothing but marketing, and they all expect that... Big ass paycheck. I saw something. It said in the last like 15 or 20 years or some shit like that, CEO paychecks or salaries have gone up something like 900% and something, whereas the average worker is at about 12 or 13%.
Yeah, because
they expect that to keep happening. That's why we pay more.
It's like the question that I asked of one of the government representatives I spoke to. I said, "How is it that you managed to pay athletes more than you pay the people that sacrifice their lives for your well-being?" And the answer I got was disheartening. And
what was the answer?
Hold on.
Corporate funding.
Hold on. Here's one thing you got to realize. It's not the athletes and who the people who are paying the military aren't the same funds. The athletes make so much money because of capitalism. It's all pure industry. Like I said, it's money from Coke, money from Pepsi, all that shit.
Are you telling me that war is in a capitalist measure?
You're looking at it kind of from a different
one is public
section.
One is
of
publicly
capitalism.
Funded and one is privately
like
funded.
Like the military
yeah.
industrial complex has nothing to do with Coca-Cola. They don't care about the NBA. They make money blowing up villages and selling the missiles that those villages then need to defend themselves.
I understand that. I'm just saying that's kind of
the corporation runs the
messed
government
up.
Too.
Oh, the military industrial complex is the largest corporation on the planet, and it makes billions of dollars annually and pads pockets of some of the most disgusting people in the planet.
Undoubtedly.
But it's not, it has nothing to do with the pay, with what
voice.
Athletes get paid.
A little basic.
Athletes get paid that because we allow them to get paid that. We pay the, we buy the tickets, we pay $8 for the fucking Coke when we go, and the fucking $12 beers.
Bro, I remember I went to a WWE event, it was $12 for a fucking cup. $12. I was just like, $12 for a cup, bro? Oh, you get unlimited drinks. What do you mean, $12 for a cup, bro?
that's why they make so much money, because we allow that to happen. I'd say stream it more. Stream it more, because the more that you stream it, the more money you're taking out of their fucking pockets, the more they have to lower their price. You want an example? Look at government weed right now.
Government
they came
weed.
In high as fuck with their prices.
They're down at 10.
And
like
they can't compete
10.
With the black market.
No,
at all. And I was in the dispensary not long ago, and a lot of their prices have dropped dramatically. You can get half quarters for 25 now. 20. I've seen half quarters for 20 bucks in there.
Wow.
That's what I mean.
Yeah, that's my voice chipping in.
But I've seen $20 half quads in there, man.
Okay.
That shit wasn't happening fucking when they first came in. No. When you look at something and say, I ain't doing that, then they have to lower the price.
Of course, and I'm about that. That's why.
But you will never see them do that for sports because no matter as much as you complain about it, you're still going to watch every game.
I don't know about every game, but a lot of the games.
You're still going to wear the merchandise.
Because I'm a patriot to a degree.
What does sports have to do with patriotism?
Representing and
are you saying that because I'm a Pittsburgh Penguins fan?
You should live in Pittsburgh,
Las Vegas fan. Then I'm
yeah, man. Separate yourself from yourself and figure out which party you want to land in and support.
The star player is Canadian on the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Oh, touche. What you got for Vegas, though?
Like half their roster is Canadian.
All right.
Fleury is their goalie.
Theo?
In the NHL.
Theon Fleury is their goalie.
Okay.
Team Canada.
Yeah, I remember. Hmm. All right, I ain't mad at you. I don't mind who you support. As long
now let's look at the actual, you know, citizenship of the Toronto Raptors. How many of them do you think are actually Canadian?
I don't know, bro. I don't go around pointing fingers when people are winning.
Yeah, you don't like this pointing back at you.
I don't point fingers when people
why
are
you rooting
winning.
For them so many of them Americans, bro? You're not patriotic.
Bro, they support, they play for, they make our country look good. That's why. Like, it's just what it is. Last year. They won their first game.
Okay.
It starts with one, fam. It starts with one. You can't say, let's not do this shit again. Oh, well, let's see if they make the playoffs. Then they make the playoffs. Let's see if they make the finals. They make the finals. Let's see if they win the championship. Check the NBA simulation. They did it last year. It wasn't wrong. You remember this.
Listen, bro. How long have they existed for?
25 years. That's perfectly fine.
Congrats. They're 1-25.
That's fine. It's one. And now they have the biggest ring in sports history. So they're still making history.
Did you
say
the biggest ring in sports history?
Yeah.
You think the NBA ring is the biggest ring in sports history? You think it's bigger than the Super Bowl ring?
The current NBA, the current.
Or are you talking about size-wise?
The current Raptors ring is bigger
size-wise.
And
okay, that's just some capitalism shit. I don't care about size.
Wait, hold on. What are you saying?
I find the Stanley Cup to be more memorable and more important to a Canadian than anything. That is our national pass. Actually, our national pastime is technically lacrosse.
Okay, finally, someone knows that. Because if you said that, if you had finished that sentence, I would have pounced like a lynx, yo. Which is one of the, you know, felines we're known for. Just keeping it Canadian.
No, I know what our national sport actually is, but what we actually kind of like treat
represent,
as our national
yeah,
sport
yeah.
is hockey. So I consider the Stanley Cup far more important than the NBA championships or the Super Bowl ring.
I think everyone does.
Yeah, it does carry more weight, literally. And
100%.
I'm going to say figuratively. All right. So we got, my microphone keeps staticking, and I don't like that. It makes it seem like I'm not professional. And I am professional.
Why are you so unprofessional, Bella?
You want to say my...
Block, block. I just called you Brock.
Check, check. Still, is it staticky?
It could be my beard.
Probably.
It could be...
I was watching a battle that was happening, bro. It was fucking up his whole mic.
Mm-hmm.
You're mixing coffee and tequila.
The fact that I'm drinking tequila at all is...
I have that effect on me.
Gross. You know what
I
mean?
Yo, I'm showing you. I'm just like...
Swill.
Swill. What is... Oh, wow. Man. So it's got to be my beard or something because it's not doing that to you.
I feel like it's in and out. But it's okay. We'll do this for now.
All right.
We each have a mic.
Yeah. So what do you... You've been quiet for the last couple of minutes. What do you have to bring to the table topic-wise?
Today?
Today, yes.
I just let you guys talk sports. I'm not really a huge, huge sports, like, buff, but...
Okay.
I brought in the capitalism talk.
I'm going to talk about capitalism.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of it.
Like, fuck all corporations.
I feel like it monetizes stress, and you're rewarded for...
It monetizes poverty.
What do you mean by that? Elaborate on that.
For Please. Capitalism to exist, there has to be a lower class.
Okay, I don't disagree with that.
No.
There needs to be somebody struggling at the very, very bottom. There needs to be an impoverished class. There needs to be a middle class. There needs to be a class system. And that's disgusting. Any society that says that a certain segment has to go hungry or homeless shouldn't exist.
So I actually have a little bit of background on this topic, like having written a couple of different, you know, dissertations that were published on this topic of capitalism. So back in the day, you could only incorporate if there was some greater public good. So you could only... If it was you and I, and we were in a partnership, and we wanted to incorporate, there had to be, you wanted to either build a railroad, or you had to, so in order to file a corporation under a corporate patent, you would have to have a larger reason for doing so. But now, it's kind of like been this runaway train, where now anyone can incorporate, and there's such a division, whereas before, we didn't have the Industrial Revolution, we didn't have all of these things.
No, yeah.
And they haven't changed those legalities. So it's actually illegal.
If you
look back at the history of a corporation in the 1800s, the 1900s, there was always some larger sort of public good that it was serving.
Mm-hmm. Switch mics.
Switch mics?
Give her your mic.
Switch mics. Oh, this one's way better.
Yeah, I think this one's dying.
Why y'all gotta take the good mic from me? What the fuck?
That's Jeez. Enough out of you tonight.
Well then, Jesus Christ, I'm just gonna sit here and fucking drink my shit.
There you go, bam.
But yeah, I mean, I think that's
I
kind
bet.
Of...
It's in the way of my drink, though.
What, this thing?
Yeah.
My bad.
Anyway, well, sorry, what were you saying?
Oh, no, I just feel like that... I definitely have a little bit of background on that, but I don't know how it's gotten such a, like, it's become such a runaway train. Like, I think...
Fear.
Because people stopped caring.
Oh, and people got greedy, too.
Yeah,
well,
fear. People got mad
no,
greedy.
No, I saw, and this is, to this day, I still think that this is one of the... Here, can I have one of the mics?
Yeah, hold on.
To this day, I still think that this is one of the... Go look it up. It's when Marilyn Manson was doing an interview after Columbine and shit, and he started talking about capitalism. And how it's all driven off of fear. And it's true. It's you know,
fear.
If you don't drink this, the hot chick's not going to want to kick it with you. If you don't wear this cologne, you're going to smell like ass. If
true.
You know, like, he went through this whole speech, and it all just made perfect sense. And everything's fear. Fear of competing with the next man.
Fear
of not
being
fitting
inadequate.
In. It's all, yeah, fear of being inadequate. It's all, and that's what drives capitalism. You find a new niche. How are you not going to fit in? Oh, you don't have this? You're not cool.
We're good. Popping.
Like, look at the price. Look at fucking iPhones and shit nowadays.
Bro, that thing is like $1,300 now. Like $1,300 to $1,700, depending on which one you're
Wild.
Getting.
Oh, shit.
Wild. I remember when I got the iPhone 5. I got the iPhone 5 before it was released.
The iPhone 3
major,
for me.
Like, to market.
Dating myself.
And, like, the things that it made possible on one side were all right, but the sacrifices that I had to make.
Why I gotta buy a computer to have a phone?
But let's talk privacy, too. Like,
Oh my gosh, the privacy of it was just.
Nowadays, we have no privacy with phones.
Yeah, no, everybody.
Nowadays, everyone tells Siri their bullshit, and then Siri spews ads back at them.
One of my favorite memes dating people is.
Take the mic. Yeah.
All right. You see it online, and it says. It says like in 2000, it says. Don't believe everything you read on the internet, and don't talk to strangers and shit. And then it says, like, 2019, it's like, order an Uber and get in a car with a stranger.
Yeah, that's...
Like, that's...
I mean, how rigorous are these background checks that Uber does? Like, I feel like I've heard horror stories. Especially in the States.
I've definitely heard horror stories.
Right?
This stuff.
Yeah, but I've heard horror stories from every cab
company.
Like,
Lyft and... Yeah, like, there's... You just never know nowadays. Anyone can be a cab driver.
Yeah, and...
Oh, can I say one thing?
Yeah.
Uber, if you ever do pay attention to this shit, make sure your drivers know how to drive.
Because
for real.
Amen.
Y'all.
I've had some extreme experiences.
Some of them I see in Toronto sometimes. I just want to drive my van right in the side of them to teach them a fucking lesson.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
So many times, bro. Like, they'll be in this lane, and then they'll have to pick up somebody over here, and they'll fucking just... No cares for anybody. Just shoot across fucking six lanes of traffic. Damn, let me do a U-turn here.
I had a friend the other day tell me that her Uber driver is going like 160. Just driving her. Like literally putting her life in danger.
That's bonkers.
That's crazy.
That's why I drive myself.
That's efficiency.
Nah, bro.
What, getting it done and getting the next ride? Like,
yo, that's what I'm saying.
Capitalism at its finest.
You're not telling me no, brother.
It's a safety thing. I mean,
yeah.
It's kind of.
If my bosses are watching, never. I drive the posted speed limit at all times.
Of course
no
you
one's
do.
Watching. Your bosses
never
are
won.
Watching.
Never won over.
Ever.
Never. Never.
Why would I disbelieve any of that statement?
I appreciate your belief.
You're appreciated here at Camping Conversations. Oh man, so
drive safe,
ladies and gentlemen.
Absolutely.
Like, well, in all seriousness,
and don't ride bikes on city streets.
Yeah, oh my gosh,
those guys kill me.
No, they like to creep up on you too, you know what I mean? And it's like they
want to cause an accident.
I had one about 5 years ago. I was pulled onto the side of the street for 10 seconds in a parking spot, sitting there, putting my smoke out, getting ready to go do my delivery. And all I hear at the back of my van is,
no.
Some fucking idiot on his bike rode his bike right into the back of my work van while I was parked in a parking spot.
No.
And then he proceeds to yell at me.
No.
Bro.
How did that go?
Oh my god, I've never had so much fun with an idiot in my life. Because
oh
there were people
goodness.
That saw that shit and were fucking, they sided with me, obviously. I'm like, I was sitting here. He's like, you cut right in front of me. I'm like. Bro, I was, like, in park.
What?
And you drove into the back. I had somebody else ride his...
Oh, my god.
Some of the shit that's happened with bikers, man, I'm surprised y'all are still alive.
Oh,
fucking, I was sitting in a construction zone, and it was too tight to really, you know, get a bike through.
Yeah.
But, of course, the idiots think that they can fit through because they think they own everything. And he fucking smokes his face off my passenger side mirror.
Oh, he did.
Yeah, bro, just... And I just happen to be looking, too. Like, I was just kind of sitting there listening to music, and I just happen to look over, and all I see is...
Oh, fuck. Oh, man, that is terrible.
Bro, some of the shit I've seen...
Great.
That's hilarious,
some of the
bro.
Shit I've seen in Toronto, man...
Can I ask a scene, like, it might seem like a silly question, but why aren't they on the sidewalk?
Because they're irresponsible there, too.
Yeah,
like, I just mean, like, I understand that there's, you know, people walking, but, like, you ding, and, like, they, instead of being on the road, endangering the lives of drivers going 100 miles an hour, or whatever, 100 kilometers an hour,
mm-hmm.
or 60, or 70, or whatever it is, if you go quick ding, and people move out of the way, and it's, like, a nice, cohesive biker/pedestrian area.
But that means everybody has to have that quick ding, and not everybody has the. Not everybody.
Maybe
buys
make
that.
That mandatory.
And that would
like
mean
I'm
that bikers
to
have to have
talk
manners.
About the system. Yeah, I guess.
And they don't. Sometimes I'll be honest. Sometimes I'll be driving, and I'll see some dude in the middle of the road, but riding his bike slow as fuck, no helmet on, no safety gear like they're supposed to wear. And all I'm thinking in my head is, well, if you ain't taking your safety seriously, why am I taking your safety seriously?
Yeah.
And I'm like.
Look out for
you. You know, maybe just a little nudge. But I can't.
No,
I
no.
I can't. You can't.
Nah, man, I could.
You want to so bad.
Oh my
so
God.
Bad.
10 points?
I came across a bike rider that was, they were riding their bike and they were in all black and it was at night and like, they rode across the light.
Dumbass!
They rode across the light and I had to slam on the brakes and I'm just like, bruh, I even put down the window like, yo, like, are you serious right now about your life? Because it doesn't seem like it. That kind of,
like, would
I don't
you
understand.
Like to die, though?
What makes someone put their life at risk like that?
I don't think that they're trying. I think that a lot of these people aren't even trying to put their life at risk. They're trying to make a statement like, I don't drive, or I'm saving the environment, which is great. I commend everybody for doing their part. Whatever your little tiny part is, do that. But when it inconveniences an entire street, or it creates traffic that's unnecessary, or you have to stop and wait for like 10 cars to go by just to be able to swerve past them, it's an issue. I think it's a public safety issue, needs to be addressed.
Yeah,
get the bikes off the fucking roads
and onto the sidewalks. Is it bumpy? Out of existence. is that why they don't like it?
Everybody like, should just ride skateboards.
Is that why?
Skateboards and rollerblades.
I don't think it's so much the buzz. I think it's more the fact that they don't want you running into people, like a car running into a bike.
How many pedestrians are there really on the you know? Like,
well, in Toronto, it'd be almost impossible to ride a bike.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I guess we're talking like it's maybe different rules for the suburbs versus the city. That could be
in the suburbs. The way I see it, I don't care what they say. If you're riding your bike in traffic and there's a wide open sidewalk,
all
you're just
over.
A dick.
I live in the
this
burbs.
Is true.
I live in the burbs, and they're all over the place.
Oh, and can I say one thing for the people in Niagara that ride bikes? If you're in the Niagara fucking Parkway, which is that road that goes along the water, and you're riding your bike on the fucking road, you're a dick. There's a fucking bike path 20 feet from you that's out of my goddamn way.
Welcome to Turf Segment, where he points out where people are,
dicks.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, let's make that a thing.
Okay, so talk about it. Let's talk about it.
You want to talk about? You want me to
when
talk
are
about
people
kind of people
dicks? When are people generally dicks when they shouldn't?
When they okay, when someone sees you coming towards a door that they are holding close enough for you to get to, and they let it close.
You know what? I have to say,
I do that.
I have to throw in the female card here. That doesn't happen to me very often. A lot of the time, people will stop and hold it. But I could see how a male to a male might be like a disrespectful thing.
I had a female do that to me.
Not gonna lie, I don't necessarily do that with doors, but just because of my job, sometimes I do that with elevators.
Oh,
you'll
no.
just shut the elevator.
Yeah, like if I'm in a service elevator somewhere,
oh,
and I'm on the service elevator and I look down and I see somebody like rushing towards the elevator, but they've got like you know a bunch of shit that they've got to put on, and I'm like, this is gonna add fucking to my day. Fuck. You know, I'll act like I'm pressing that button, bro, but I'm not pushing it in.
You know what's hilarious?
Oh,
whenever I'm on my elevator, this is
like, oh, sorry, I'm pushing the other button. I'm pushing the close button.
Me
I'm like,
too. This is where I'm about to go.
Fuck, yo, bro. I got you.
I live in a condo on the 18th floor. So
okay.
Let's talk about that. In the morning, everyone's going to work. Like, I mean, luckily I work from home. Thank you. Thank you for all the, you know, things
yeah.
that I've done to get me there.
That's
but.
A
it's a luxury, but I've worked for
blah,
it.
Blah, blah.
Hey, let's not start.
Don't
but
worry,
either way,
good,
what
good.
I'm trying to say is I'm one of those people who, like, it's like stops on, like, 17, 16, 50, like, picking people up on the way, you know, wherever. And then I'm the type of person, same as you, like, I'll rush to the elevator. I, like, hear something, I, like, close. Like, it just takes too long. Especially being like at that, it's just like you're stopping all over the place and you're stopping on the way down.
I lived on the 35th floor of a building in Hamilton once.
Oh my God.
And I would have to leave like 20 minutes early for work. 100%. I worked literally right across the street almost. And I would have to leave like 20 minutes early for work just because the elevator sometimes could take me 10, 15 minutes.
It makes me late for my meetings. Say I have a meeting and I don't account for the elevator time, it's like a 15 minute. sometimes just like standing there, and you can't walk 18 down, like 18 floors down. Like
I learned that I could run 35 floors.
You're like a sweaty hog in your like nice clothes. When you know what I mean? Like you're just, it doesn't work. You can't do it.
We used to get all high and run up and down my stairs, 35 floors.
Ah, yeah. That's a lot.
Yeah.
Good cardio.
That's bonkers, bro.
Yeah, I was really high.
That's bonkers. I used to walk 17, like one down.
Now I don't even like going up or downstairs in my house.
Oh my gosh.
Like
don't
one
even,
floor.
Yo.
Want to go get this from upstairs? Wait till something else has to happen upstairs.
Gotta get them done, like, I mean.
Amalgamating.
Yep.
Think of a few more reasons for me to go up there, and then I'll. Give me a few more reasons to go upstairs, and then I'll, you know, work my way up there slowly, but I might lie down while I'm up there.
I intentionally find something to do on the middle floor. If I have to go to the top floor for anything from down here, I intentionally find something on the middle floor to do because...
Like, I'm gonna make a sandwich or something.
You know what I mean? Like, cause it's, like, to do it straight, a straight shoot, like, you feel the burn in your thighs, bro. By the time you're on the second step, on the second flight, you're feeling that burn, and you're winded, and it's just like, nah. I shouldn't sound like this. I am not that old, but...
Yeah, you've been doing your Wii Fit and everything. Like,
you know what? Let's talk about it. I've literally just recently put this on. Do you guys believe that this is accurate?
What is it?
Yeah.
I don't know what it is.
It's not a Fitbit. It's a Garmin because I don't like the whole Fitbit, like, watching you sleep and, like, telling you all your... Like, it's too much. This one's just more, like, steps. I get my phone notifications on here. I got weather. I got, like, how many kilometers I walked, how many floors up I walked that day.
Okay.
Like, so it's got your average heart rate.
I see that.
So it's more of a health kind
of thing. You know what I learned about those things?
What?
And this was because a military base was actually outed because of those things, is they track your movements.
Where you're going.
Like,
yeah.
Where you're going and stuff like that. And
yeah.
A military base... Was outed
Google
by
Maps.
That because somebody had, like, hacked into it or whatever, and was able to find, like, a soldier that was wearing them, and, like, that knew that they were out there.
That's fucking crazy.
So when it comes to shit like that, yeah, I don't. I already have a phone that can track me that way. I don't need them to
know
my exact,
like,
steps.
I feel like, so I have Google Maps, and, like, the other day I literally looked through my history and I was.
I'm Google famous.
I literally made it delete.
Were you one of the guys wearing a horse head on Google Maps?
No, I was one of the. If you Google my address, which I'm not going to tell you on.
I'm not telling you on the live,
but if you Google my address, you'll actually see me outside sanding my car. This is true. If you look on Google Earth.
Sanding your car?
Sanding my car. It was the Jimmy.
Was this the one that had all the decals?
That's
and shit
one that
on
had
it?
All the decals and
can
the
we talk about that for a minute?
Oh my gosh, can we? Holy shit!
When I met this man, hold on, he was driving the loudest,
just like the cup.
Like the cup.
Oh, it was
louder than the cup.
Oh, the whole van was just sparkle paints and.
Oh.
Did some of it glow?
Did you see the black? Were you like, did you see the black and gold?
Yes.
And the black and gold and the red. Did you ever see the red and gold and black?
Yes, because I was there. I met you when it was like that, and then you painted it black.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And you had all the shit on, like, the wind on the side and shit. Bro.
Yeah, bro.
Bro.
It was like, sometimes I'll get memories on Facebook and it'll show you pictures of it. I'm like, you know what I mean?
So what
how
happened?
Thick,
like,
was the paint on that final?
The paint was on the final one. It was at least 8 layers. At least.
Guys, I'm high.
Okay, so what happened was nice.
That happened really, really, like, off, like, the tiniest little puff, and now I'm like, yeah.
Smoke weed
just
every day.
Just have to tell you guys.
Okay, we appreciate the info.
Would you like some more of this?
shit, why not? But what happened was, I became friends with an individual who wasn't really friends with me the way I thought. He convinced me to take it mudding. We took it mudding. Fucked up the engine a little bit. Then I was supposed to get it fixed. But decided to buy his car. So then we destroyed that car. And I paid for the truck.
His car?
His car. Yeah, I bought his car from him.
After you destroyed it.
After I destroyed my car.
Oh, wow.
Put sound system and everything in there. And then he had his wife come and steal it back because he's just a cocksnot that wanted to be very controlling.
Yeah.
And he wanted to control the situation. Exactly. He's a dick. He wanted to control the situation, and I wasn't willing to be controlled. So.
What a dick.
Mm-hmm.
Dickhead. Whoever it is.
No, he's kind of like the dick shaft, actually.
The dick what?
The dick shaft.
The dick shaft?
Oh, yeah. Okay. No one ever talks about that. Am I wrong? Am I wrong?
No.
Exactly. Who's out here now? All right. Fuck me, you're right. I said, how you doing, bro?
Who is that?
Zone.
What's good, Zone?
I said, how you doing, fam? Like.
Yeah.
Okay, I need a lighter, but, like, I can't use a Zippo for that. I'll just put this out.
It's probably safer for you.
Yeah, probably safer for me. All right, so.
They're scared of my lighters, y'all.
I ain't scared of your motherfucking nothing.
All right, let's hit it with this.
Bruh.
He's standing back and shit.
Don't watch face, but it's safe than sorry. I see you trying to move it forward. It ain't got to go any further than that, bro. It's a powerful flame. I see that shit. Well, yes, welcome to Candid Conversations. Tune in on Friday if you have any like for battle rap, where we'll talk about, or we're on Hardline. Jeez. Terp, you want to clean that one up for me?
Fridays, we do Hardline. Discussing Let's Beef, battle rap, wide array of topics surrounding the hip-hop community.
Well done.
Yeah.
Thank you. I appreciate that. You know what I mean? Like, you got to know your team and what they're able to do. You know what I mean? That's just what it is.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm high as a motherfucker right now.
I'm sitting here feeling like I'm floating and shit. I'm not even going to lie. Oh, man. What up, Denise? How you doing?
Victoria's still watching.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so is there any topic she wants to hear an opinion on?
Yeah, Tori. She said it's 5 minutes lag day. She literally said.
Timed it? Okay.
No, she said that she saw me pick up my phone to text her back.
Oh.
Right? Because I just wanted to see.
Pass me a heater.
Are we okay? Sure, we are right over here.
Up and I'm like, what are you doing? I can't hear it right now. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck.
Okay, that actually is hilarious when you explain it.
I'm telling you, it works wonders. Oh, my gosh. No, I'm handing it to him, and he moves his head up, and I'm like, what are you doing? But I'm like, okay.
I'm going to have to watch out on the replay, bro. I'm going to fucking put that shit right under my fingertips.
Never. I wouldn't do it. Yo, honestly, I wouldn't do that. I even went to slide my hand, and I'm just like, no. It was like, no. And your hand just reached for it, and I couldn't take it. I couldn't move it or nothing.
All right, well, how about we go back to the first topic that we had that we never really discussed?
Okay.
You mentioned the block to Quebec Law, and then we kind of...
Oh, no. I was just trying
ended up here.
I was just being an ass still.
The election. How do you feel about the result?
Oh, how do I feel about the result, personally? I told my daughter, sometimes you got to stick with evil, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's literally exactly how I felt.
I don't know if you're willing to say this, but who did you vote for?
Oh, man. Honestly, because I coined the phrase, have a good and liberal day, and it actually caught on within the liberal campaign, I stuck with the evil I knew.
So you voted for Trudeau?
Yeah. Well, I technically voted for Badaway, which in turn voted for Trudeau. So yeah, okay. Yeah.
No, that's understandable. Better than blue.
Yeah.
Victoria has some topics.
Okay.
What about you? Who'd you vote for?
You know what?
Unless you don't want to say.
I picked the lesser of two evils, I feel.
So you voted for the liberals?
I don't like them, like, at all. But I feel like this is the election that was the lesser of all evils. I hated every candidate. This is the first time.
Can y'all just give the NDP a chance once? They got
just
some
one
really
time.
Good ideas.
It's not.
They're more liberal than y'all.
Okay, listen. So.
Hey,
To the left.
I don't think any.
To the right.
I don't think. Like, I got a lot of, like, socialist
views.
And
then you should be going NDP, bro.
Bro, until the NDP works with me as well as the liberals have, or liberals did.
You're just as about as socialist as, well, maybe not quite, but almost as socialist as I am.
Almost? Okay.
I would burn this motherfucker down if I could.
Okay. Yeah. No, I'm not even gonna go there.
But anyway.
Yeah.
I digress.
I digress. Like, he completely forgot what the fuck he was talking about. That's what happened right there.
Nah, bro.
What's up, Victoria? All right. What up, patterns? Oh, man.
Nah, bro. If you want to go,
does she have a
the farther left you go, you got to go.
She didn't type it.
NDP has hopes in hell of winning seats. Green would be nice.
Green would be
as far left as possible as we have in Canada.
I worked with the Green Party candidate and tried to help get him in a position.
And can
position.
I say one thing? Modern day socialism is not communism.
Oh my goodness. I don't know about this one. Is that the rest of it?
Sick of people saying that socialism is communism. It is not communism.
So on Hardline, apparently I get really high, and on Candid Conversations, apparently I'm supposed to get drunk.
You don't have to.
I know I don't have to, but
there's no force pushing you.
Peer pressure.
You know what I mean, though? But at least I was told that there was alcohol before I drank a beer. Thank you. I appreciate that.
That's a subtle shot at me.
Why
was it subtle? No, it just doesn't work well for me.
Oof. Your face that day was classic. Wait, there's alcohol?
Yep. Oh my gosh.
Okay, what topics does she have?
She said first. Okay, so she said it's 30, like a lot more, 30 second delay, not 5. But she also said we should discuss Joker the movie or like the topic of like depression and the
I haven't
age.
Seen the Joker yet, so
I
we can do
Joker
the
yet.
Other one.
Okay. Yeah, but it's like the same ideas, like the topic of becoming the most evilest form of anything in society.
So like,
as
a
result
so you
want to
talk about like how like society can just drive a person into a deep
mental
dark pit until they hit like.
Oh, you mean like Cheshire Black?
Desperation.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was her first.
We're musicians. We can nail that one.
Let's talk about it.
All right. So I'll. Okay, I think depression comes from a lack of support. I firmly believe depression stems from a lack of support and excess pressure to accomplish.
Okay. So can I actually talk about something that I've learned in recent years? So I read this study, big intense study done on rats, okay? And it was like addiction versus anything else. Or depression. Like, there were so many topics in this study. So, they gave the rats a bunch of blow, like cocaine. So, the ones that had, like, a network of other rats to chill with didn't become, like, crazy addicted and, like, didn't touch the shit because they were, like, friendly with their people kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
I know this is really fucking out there, but...
No.
Then,
we're touching base on
then,
a real serious topic.
And
right
then,
now.
The rats that were isolated... alone with a blow, canister, or whatever the fuck, they did it till they died. So that's exactly how much support people need. Like, I really do believe in that type of, like, isolation, or feeling left out, or feeling like somewhere you don't fit, and you have nobody, I think that's where it kind of comes from.
Patterns a young OG, yeah.
I have to say, like, that's, I really believe that.
I think that could be... some like that could have an impact on it, but there could also be, there's some people out there that suffer that have an amazing support group around them, but they personally don't necessarily know how to like convey
interact.
Their issues,
right?
And that so at that point, you know, they could have the support and still suffer.
So, like, you look at some celebrities that died. Like, you figure they got to have amazing support groups.
Like Robin Williams.
Yeah, like somebody like Robin Williams fucking, he still goes and fucking.
Yeah, but don't you think if someone puts you to a puts you on a pedestal, so to speak, is that like.
The pressure.
I hate the term depression. And that's just because.
Why?
Like, because I think it should be. There should be different versions of it, as stupid as it sounds. Like, isolation style, there's pressure-based depression that you can get where you never feel like you're going to amount to what people expect of you. Like, there's different forms of depression, but we all just kind of lump it as depression.
I agree with that.
Okay.
And I think that is where there's a huge issue, because then people don't know how to deal with depression. They think, well, I can't be depressed, even though I feel this way, because
I have this,
and I don't fall in this category. So those people don't reach out. Because they think everyone's just going to think I'm crazy. And that's where I think you get all these celebrities that off themselves. Because they think, because everyone probably looks at them and says, you have everything you fucking want. You've got the beautiful wife, the great family, millions of dollars. What? Basically, meanwhile, they're just like, I just want to have a real conversation with somebody, but nobody will listen.
Basically what I was trying to say, like, once you're put on a pedestal, so to speak, your life, or once your life looks pristine, nobody expects you to have problems. You know
and also,
I mean?
You have nothing really left to strive for. So I feel like that's a big part.
Once I got to a point that my life was okay, I started helping other people. I started working with other people.
Absolutely, but you're not everybody. Like, some people don't go that way, right? So they have goals, and they're like, I attained these goals. I have nothing.
Yeah, like,
I'm
now
empty
what do I do?
Now.
Yeah, yeah,
right?
Yeah,
like,
okay, yeah.
That's how I'm like. Kinda
it's like when old people have work all their lives, and then they retire, and then they die 6 months later. Like
they need
to going
to
work was having
yeah.
something to do was what
a
kept
purpose.
Them alive.
Yeah.
That's facts.
It's true. True. Oh man.
That's a pretty
got
good
a little
topic.
Morbid.
You know what though? It's a topic that
it's
needs
a
to
topic
be discussed.
That's good.
It is.
Like,
life
think...
is a cycle.
Yeah.
And it's never really just taken seriously. I think people are just starting to take it seriously.
Yo, on this stats can I
tell you something in all honesty though? Like, that Let's Talk campaign, that's something that needs to actually apply itself throughout the course of the year more often as opposed
than, like,
to just one that
day.
One day.
Oh, it does. It
you
does,
know what I mean?
For sure.
Like,
for sure.
The fact that it started, great idea, whoever came up with it or whoever contributed
I'm
to
really
it.
I'm really happy about that.
You know what I mean? But
well.
At the same time,
campaign?
Yeah, it needs to effectively address or use its profits to improve the quality of the lives of the people who are experiencing these mental health complications, as opposed to just racking up in Bell's accounts.
Well, that's definitely true.
Agree.
Well, see, that's what happens when you have... See, the main issue with things like depression is there's no profit when you cure it. There's a profit when you have somebody that returns for the prescription.
That is correct.
Yeah.
And that's the same with a lot of sicknesses, but it's especially like that with like mental health drugs.
Totally.
I thought he was gonna say the C word.
What?
Okay, he didn't say it.
Let's not.
We're good.
I'm really stoned
okay
right now.
Yeah.
Oh, capitalism.
Oh, damn.
Big pharma.
Yeah.
We monetized healthcare. Once you monetize something like healthcare,
you're fucked.
People aren't gonna give a fuck about health. They're gonna care about the money.
So, I actually just did a, I was telling them before you got here, I did, on my drive here, I got a call from Stats Canada, and
okay,
I gave so much input on the healthcare industry. They literally asked me so many questions. It was about 40 minutes on the phone with them. I was like, how long is this going to take? I'm like, great, I have a 40-minute drive. Like,
next
this
week,
is
bro.
Great.
Next week. We'll link you up on the, I don't know if we can do next week or the week after. No, go ahead.
No.
Okay.
Answer the question. It's fine.
No, I was saying, Zone was saying, he should link him up on the show. I was saying, probably not next week, but the week after. Because next week, we're going to have to be, like, candid and quick. Because we have the show.
The Halloween
party.
Oh, you got
party.
That thing.
I got
oh,
the
yeah.
Halloween party after. So, yeah.
Good memory over here.
Yeah, man. So, it's going to be
I
live.
I remember music lyrics, so that's it.
By the way, we are going to be having a Halloween event. The Halloween pop-up party. Hosted by presented by Exposed North, hosted by yours truly, David the Block Tyrell, going to be held at Borderline, which is at 607 King Street in Welland. Check it out. We're going to be having a costume optional party. We have a few hip-hop acts. We got a few other acts as well. We got a comedian coming through.
He's so buzzed, he ain't even trying it this time. He's just going general.
Very general.
It is what it is, though.
We're going to have some shit y'all can see.
Some fun y'all can participate in.
Hope y'all gonna like it. There's gonna be some stuff amazing. There. Some peeps y'all might know.
There's gonna be some food. You know what I mean? Don't even ask me what kind.
It's gonna happen on some day at some point.
Happens on Wednesday, October 30th,
2019. Okay, I'm so sorry. I don't
want to
be laughing
at the start. At Borderline in Welland.
Oh, wait, is next King Thursday Street. Halloween?
Yeah, next,
Thursday
next Halloween. Wednesday, isn't
and
it?
Next Wednesday's the event. Next Thursday's Halloween. On Halloween night, I gotta go to Lux to go to Dalton's event.
No.
What?
I don't know. I'm just not ready for Halloween yet.
Oh, man. It's already Christmas, according to the Corporate Society.
Do we even want to get started on Christmas?
Bro, honestly, I the fact that when
there
I
is nothing less Christian...
Then Christmas. Agreed. I'd agree with that.
Y'all motherfuckers done taking a fucking story about a dude born in June and somehow involved a fat dude, flying reindeer, a sack of gifts, sleigh.
Capitalism.
Elves.
Like, we have to
trees.
Because you can create anything you believe
and
in.
Buy.
Now, if we can just realize that that's mostly pagan stuff, and then we can move on with our day.
You want to explain what pagan is too now?
Paganism.
Just explain it to those who don't know.
Basically, like, it's the oldest religion. It was the original belief. I don't have the definition of it right in front of me.
Oh, okay. I figured you would.
No.
Okay.
But it's where a lot of rituals come from nowadays, especially Christian rituals. Bringing the trees inside, it was, you know, winter solstice shit.
Interesting. I did not know that.
Continue.
No, you're looking offended over there, bro.
Oh, no. Offended? Me? Never.
He's like, yo, you can rip on anything you want. You ain't take Christmas from me. Motherfucker.
You can say whatever you want. I don't have to necessarily adopt your perspective on it. It's just interesting to hear that, you know... I'm surprised to hear that for someone who goes through the lengths that you go through for Christmas, that this is actually your perspective.
Oh, I love it, but out of, like, the, like...
Tradition?
Just the festiveness of it has nothing to do with any religious aspect.
Yeah, he almost said the spirit.
I was gonna say the feeling of it. But
okay.
Like,
spirit.
It's, no. It's just,
let's talk about spirit.
The feeling of community you get with Christmas.
Okay. Yeah, but that's the spirit
that's
at its
the best
highest
part.
Form.
And then the story, but I'm not talking
am
about
I
like
wrong?
Like I don't celebrate the Christian story.
Right?
Like, I'm the guy who I have a nativity scene, ironically, and I put like Stewie Griffin in there and like dinosaurs and shit. I have.
You're observing it in your own fashion.
But I love like you know, the Tiny Tim story, like all that shit, like. Scrooge and all that. That's fucking dope. That story, that's dope. So I, you know, Christmas time, that shit comes out. Fucking The Grinch.
Home Alone.
So you're all
for
about
me.
The, like, the, what's it called? The Ghost of Christmas Past. What's it called? What's that movie called? Oh, damn it.
Scrooge is, like, the best Christmas movie of all time. Bill Murray.
Well, they talk about The Ghost of Christmas Past, The Ghost of Christmas Past.
They do that in Scrooge.
Yeah.
Oh, you talking about A Christmas Carol?
Yeah, is that what it's called?
Yeah, that's the original.
That's the original. Yeah.
They did the story like 20 times, but yeah.
Oh, that.
But Scrooge is
the
best
version.
Scrooge is the best version. Bill Murray. If you've never seen it, watch it.
I believe I've seen it. Bill Murray's a goat.
100%.
100.
But yeah, for Christmas, I celebrate it for that shit. I have the tree, but I have like Beavis and Butthead angels.
And please don't take this or pervert this. I like giving. Because I feel like I'm doing something for somebody when
so
I
do
that.
So do I. I spoil at Christmas.
Form.
I spoil at Christmas.
Oh my gosh.
I spoil at Christmas.
Like all the time. Like and
I hate getting shit at Christmas. I hate when people buy me shit.
Oh my gosh, my niece like I show, did I show
it.
You the watch?
Yeah.
I just got
anything I want, I'll buy myself. I'm good.
I agree with that.
I haven't worn another watch since the last 3 years since my wife got me this one.
Yo, can I say something to what you just said?
And, I got a gift. Go ahead.
No. Were you in the middle of it?
Yeah, I got a gift, and I still don't know. I got a gift, and I still don't know what to do about it, because, it was unexpected from someone I didn't expect it, and...
Ooh,
you know what I mean? You're always, thankful as fuck when that happens, but then you're just like...
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
I don't feel the same.
It's not even like it was... Exactly. It's not even like it was a crap gift or anything that, you could just easily one-up it.
Like, yo, bro, here's your Pepsi, man. Thanks for buying me that fucking bag of chips.
You know what I mean?
No, for sure.
Like, yo.
Oh, my God.
Like,
thank
you.
Yeah.
Sometimes all you need is a thank you, though,
that's
I think.
That's literally what I would say.
I mean, gift-giving shouldn't involve reciprocity.
Not at all.
Okay, cool. I'm glad you believe that. But a thank you is like for a card. Or, something under $20.
No.
No, obviously you want to say thank you for whatever you get.
Yeah, but, I don't think, if you're giving a gift expecting to receive something necessarily in return, then you're not giving the gift genuinely.
Then you're not in the spirit.
I know this
giving.
Person wasn't expecting to receive a gift.
That's almost what makes it worse.
Exactly what I'm
not expecting to receive.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying.
But you're also not in any obligation to
return. I understand that, but that in turn makes the obligation more detrimental. It does. If you're looking at the whole, if we're looking at the essence of giving, right? And I want to say the karmic.
The essence of giving is more the
it's
joy you
yourself.
Get watching somebody else
it's
receive.
It's for yourself. Not,
exactly.
Yeah.
So as someone who would be considered to be like.
So is giving a gift in this situation more beneficial for them or for you and yourself?
It'd kind of be more beneficial for me and myself.
How's that?
To give a gift that was equally received because
exactly.
of my because of my nature.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Give a gift. That's what would make you feel better.
The only problem is she probably won't receive the gift and I'm not even sure what gift it is to give. So
sounds hectic.
It sounds so hectic, bro. Like
basket of muffins.
Basket of
dozen donuts.
Edible options, edible arrangements, or edible options. Check out edible.
You think about
options.
Edible options or edible options?
We went there.
Definitely, just edible options.
What if you send them as edible options, but they're really edible options?
Hold on.
Okay, so I wanted to say something.
Mickey Mouse Christmas story is a Mickey Mouse Christmas story is the best one. Jenny says.
Ooh. I think we're about to have our first disagreement, Jenny. Scrooged, followed by very closely a Christmas story.
Oh man, I don't.
I like a Christmas story.
A Christmas story is like a classic movie.
Miracle on 34th Street.
No.
Nah.
I fall asleep every time.
I wanted to say yes, but then I was like,
nah. It's honestly for its message is really good.
I do. I like.
I don't
want
Christmas
but
stories
no,
for their
you're
message.
You're forgetting
for the
original OG.
That's different. It's
fine. You're forgetting the OG Christmas one. Rudolph, yo.
Bro, have you rewatched Rudolph in the last 10 years?
All.
Yeah, bro.
No,
it
I
does
don't
not
like
age
it.
Well,
no.
bro. I watch it and I'm just like, what the fuck was I into when I was a kid? It looks like shite.
It looks like it's possessed. Like
it doesn't
possessed.
Look good.
Everything just looks creepy now. I'm like,
yeah,
yo, no wonder I had nightmares. Jesus, fuck. Y'all were showing me this and when I'm supposed to be happy and shit, y'all showing me these... demented ass fucking toys and shit.
Oh,
nobody
man.
Loves them. What kind of message is that? Nobody loves you. Go live on a fucking island somewhere.
That's oh not, my god. Not.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Well, don't they come back from the island? Spoiler alert.
They had to break them motherfuckers' selves. Like, it's not like anybody came for them. It was like, I love you as you are. It was like, we're gonna force ourselves on society as the freaks that you know us
I
as.
I love you as you are.
Yeah. So isn't that what the freaks of nature have to do anyways?
Ooh, back.
Is that really a Christmas message though?
It's a
point and laugh. They're gonna come anyway.
Would elves not be considered a freak of nature though?
Yeah, that's
if we are nature.
Yeah,
elves. Sorry, I gotta start from up here.
Well,
elves like I'm down there.
Elves, yes. Elves would be a freak of nature.
Okay.
Unfortunately, I mean it's kind of.
But they represent society in that.
Okay.
Are we sure?
It's a story about acceptance, bro.
Yeah. Oh, I get it.
That's how depressing is that?
You're telling me that a story about acceptance is depressing?
Merry Christmas! If you're lucky enough to have a home. Otherwise, people don't love you.
Bro, listen, there was no room at the
end. Find other weirdos.
There was no room at the end on occasion for a brother. So I can tell you right now that I'm cheersing because I no longer have to deal with that shit.
Mm. Well, that's what's up.
Yes.
No, some Christmas stories are just fucked up.
Yes, I agree.
Like, some of them are just mental.
Mm.
What is that?
Peach mango juice. Home Alone. Mm-mm.
I love the movie.
That's my favorite movie.
But somebody needs to call CAS now.
Wait a minute. How much money do you make per hour to be able to bring 9 people on a trip to motherfucking Paris?
Yo, McAllister's dad was definitely selling the blow. 100%. Yo, you see that house?
That house was balling, yo.
You see that? You see all them electronics back then?
Remember when he was like pulling the
all the toys?
Yeah.
He's got 100 toys and he's got like mannequins on top of them.
And he just
is
able to take 2 weeks off straight up to pay for his entire family for the entire trip.
It's not impossible. Like,
architecture. He had to be an architect or something. It's not impossible.
I have a different view of I feel like let's not go to
no
like,
she has a different view. We
wads of cash
believe,
on them.
Okay, so I believe money is also an energy that you either call in or you push out based on your thought pattern, based on your history, based on your work ethic, based on a lot of things. Like there are ways that you can hustle your fucking ass off.
Did you see his neighborhood? He was selling blow.
Yeah, the blow was
no maybe like, maybe he was connected.
Selling you know, something. McAllister was selling blow. The trench coat?
Yeah, the trench coat was, yo, the trench coat was on some
motherfucker
was
running
shit,
with a trench coat and a scarf, hair slicked a little bit. Come on.
Yeah, he had some OG tendencies, like when he pulled out the wad of cash and painted the bellhop or
yeah,
whatever.
Everything was just wads of cash, bro. Yep. He was, man.
Is that the conspiracy behind this? Like, did we just ruin Home Alone?
We might have. Sorry if you haven't seen it yet, but like.
No, but for me.
No.
Like, I love
plus, how movie. High you gotta be to not realize you're like you're missing a kid.
Yo. Well, how many? Like, let's talk about fertility for a second. 9?
No, they were like.
No, there was like 4 of them were.
Like,
I think 4 of them were there.
They were like cousins.
The other ones were cousins.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But still, yeah, like.
Also, you know, yeah, fertility. Yeah.
That family used to fucking. I don't know, maybe.
Chill the fuck out.
Maybe she's the one making the money.
Yo, honestly, oh well. If y'all knew what he meant, you wouldn't be laughing with him. Stop that.
I mean, the kids don't exactly look alike.
No, they don't really. I'm saying the mailman, the milkman, the mailman, and the milkman.
I went there, Miss McAllister.
Oh my goodness, that's great. What other movie from that time was preposterous? Let's talk about preposterous plots.
Jingle All the Way. Great movie.
Oh, terrible.
But they flew at the end.
They flew. That.
How are you going to make a suit for a parade that actually flies?
Wait, what?
That Turbo Man suit actually flew in the air. How unsafe is that? For like a Macy's Day Parade or whatever.
You're supposed to suspend your disbelief, bro.
Not when 99% of the movie is like an accurate portrayal of society.
Come on. I mean,
capitalism. Here's the toy that everybody has. That's literally all it is. Here's the toy that everybody has to have. Go.
That's kind of gross. That's
part fatherhood, bro.
No, but that's the part I hate least about Christmas.
And the worst part
is running around and being crazy, and it's like, that's not the spirit.
The worst part is they always
wrong,
release that
opposite,
toy in December.
Abort mission, like, opposite.
I start Christmas shopping, like, next week. They always release the toy that everyone
well,
has to have
you.
In, like, December.
That's
and
nice.
It drives me insane.
Oh, I wanted to say something about what you said earlier. You know how you said you're a giving person, and that's, like, what gets you, makes you happy, and it's perfect, right? Like, that's how you like to be. And you said you hate receiving gifts.
Yeah.
So what if someone else feels that way about giving you a gift? The way you feel giving someone else a gift.
Mm.
So does that change the way that you think about maybe receiving a gift?
I'd still be gracious about
it. Of course, you have to be gracious. Graciousness is a number one, like, I
of course
believe in that. So
I don't know. I'm just not a fan.
I don't.
Just not big on receiving shit like that. I do for myself.
But I also think you're, like, blocking blessings, like, whatever, if you want to call it a blessing or, like, an energy or, like, a better opportunity, however you want to label it, are you blocking that by being like, no?
That's a good question.
That's how I
feel.
Let's
talk about it.
Well, I never say no, but I say, like, if people ask what I want, I just say, I don't know, get me nothing. I'm good.
Yeah, I understand but yeah.
Exactly what she's saying. What if that situation that you say
is,
like, supposed
it
to happen
your
for you?
View
like,
of it, right?
Then I receive the gift graciously because I'm not a dink.
No, just receive it graciously because you would want someone to receive your gift graciously.
Yeah, you
can. Literally, you can put every spin
yeah,
on it.
I guess. I just
yeah, that's
I just hate when
right?
when I hate when people spend money on me. I hate it.
No, but do you know what I mean? Like, when you when
that
when
explains
you
a lot.
Look,
that explains a lot.
But when you
but
look,
why do you why
when
does
you perceive
it
differently?
Because growing up, I didn't have fuck all, so I worked my ass off to get to where I can take care of myself
and your family.
Yeah, exactly. And
yeah.
I'm good.
And you're not perpetuating the cycle that you went through.
Exactly.
Right. Well, then you made a friend in the wrong dude, bro. Because, like, some way or another, I'm going to find you something that you never expect to get, but that you'll appreciate. That's just what I do. You know what I mean?
You'll really, like...
It'll take time, because, you know, I have to get a better understanding, but, like...
How long have y'all known each other?
Oh, man.
Four years now?
Yeah.
That's not short.
No. It's been some time still. And, like, in the last year is actually when we've made the most music together.
Yeah.
So, we got, like, if you go on any streaming platform, you can check out We Gon' Shine. If you tune into Hardline, you'll hear the intro track, Hardline. Man, we got the one on all streaming platforms, Miss Dearly. Whew. There's so
poor
many.
One's going up like this week.
Poor one's going up this week. like I think we have at least 8 to 12 like collaborations.
Probably about that, yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's just with us two. That's just like the ones that I can say the two of us are on it. Like,
excellent.
He's got his own set of tracks up online. I got my own set of tracks online. He goes by Interp on all streaming platforms. You're the only Interp on any streaming platform, yes?
Facts.
Okay, I'm the only DeBlock on all streaming platforms.
Surprised.
Aren't you, though?
That's surprising.
100%.
A 100. When I signed up for this show, kid, I'm like...
You were like, thank God.
I was ready to be disappointed, and I'm just like, okay, and I typed
Enter.
It in. Enter. This name is available.
That's
I'm like,
I would have gone to war, bro. I would have started dissing the motherfuck out of whoever. I don't care if it was some fucking like Spanish dude that didn't even know what I was saying. I'd been like, that's my motherfucking name. Changing that shit.
You know what happened? I'll tell you what happened.
Aggressive.
Top on, top left.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, man. Top on is top left. I went into this. I used to play Call of Duty online. No, every Friday. Every Friday, I'd go online, I'd play Call of Duty. So then this one guy, DeBlock ENT, came online. I kid you not, I said, yo, we're playing for the name. My team smashed his team.
Good.
I bet he still kept the name.
He probably kept his name still, but, you know. I'm surprised even after going to that encounter that DeBlock was still available. You know whose name wasn't available?
Whose?
Stutz.
Really?
That's
yeah.
strange. Stutz
EP, there's
that.
Another... Apparently, there's another Stoddy P.
Stoddy P.
Another Stoddy P.
With a P at
well
the
then.
End.
Yeah.
That's fucked.
Yeah.
That's not a name you would think would be taken.
No. You'd think in hip-hop, there'd be another The Block somewhere.
The Block.
The Block.
So that's why I thought outside the box for my name.
Yeah.
I didn't want to have to compete.
No.
Interp sounds amazing. I don't know what the fuck it is, because I don't
short
know.
For interpret.
Okay.
Because my name originally was Interpret. Just kind of got shortened over the years.
Yeah.
That's a really excellent name. Like,
yeah.
That's a very interpret.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Solid name, you know what I mean? From Solid Dude. Yeah.
And a huge asshole.
Also a dick.
Like, I'd say like a dolphin because I could be a whale.
Ooh.
I can be. Awesome. But no, you have your days. I'm not gonna lie. You have. I'm not even trying to provoke that either.
What are you trying to say, Blog? Battle on Friday.
Okay, buddy. Like, yo,
60-second rounds.
60-second rounds. You saying you want to go line for line?
Nice. Okay.
Drop it. Oh, I gotta go line for line. Oh man, we're supposed to be working together to get the rest of these people online. So, oh man, check out letsbeef.com if you are in the realm of battle rap. And tune in to Hardline with Interp and The Block on Spreaker.com or on Facebook, what you're watching right now. Facebook
That's you Live. Guys, right?
That's y'all.
There.
Boom.
Instagram, Miss May.
Boom. Instagram, yes, Miss May. M-A-I-E?
Yeah.
Yes, Miss May.
Highly unique.
Amazing. I tell you,
I've heard that a lot. It's not the first time.
Okay,
but it's okay. It works.
I still like it. It works. It's so. How do you like? What can you do with David, really?
The vlog.
Not that much.
We kind of got fucked.
Yeah, I know, right? Although they couldn't banana fan or full fan of our names.
No, our names didn't really rhyme with too much shit.
Banana
folk. Although there was the old Davy Crockett shit.
Oh, I got that all the time.
Yo, Dave is rhymeable.
Bro, I just wore it, bro. I got a fucking coonskin cap.
No.
Wore it to school, bro. I was you go say it, I'm going to wear it.
For those of you who might take offense, a raccoon.
Raccoon skin. Raccoon skin cap.
No, society's sensitive as fuck nowadays, bro.
Yeah, you can't see shit.
How do you think if I look at someone without a smile on my face, it's a problem, eh? Like, it's not to screw up their face, like, like they just smelled shit or something. Just they get that little bobblehead motion. Just well, what's wrong with you?
Keep going.
What's wrong? What are you looking at? I was like, my bad, I forgot to smile at your ass. You know what I mean? You're looking at me like you've never seen someone of my kind before. Can we just realize that I exist and move on? You know what I mean? Like, shit.
You're definitely talking about old white ladies.
No, I'm not even not
Is
even
that
old
a
white.
Thing?
Not,
Do you feel like it's a Welland thing?
It's a Welland thing for sure. It's not even old white ladies because I've seen, and I don't even like the term old white ladies, but because you said it, I'm gonna refer you refer
I
to
it.
It. No,
said
no,
it.
He said
okay,
it.
Okay.
Old white ladies.
No, I've seen
sure.
Karens.
I've seen
Karen Bob haircut. Slanted Bob.
The worst part about it is, I know
you
a
know
Karen.
A Karen that fits the description.
I know a Karen. that could
to all you Karens out there.
But like,
ask to see the manager. I dare you.
I was in the grocery store and I saw a woman reach an elderly Caucasian woman reaching for something. And because I knew I had the height to reach for it, I'm like, is there anything specific that you'd like to get? She's like, yes, the hell of a good dip. I said, okay, I'll get that for you. I got it and I reached it. She's like, would you be a deer and reach the other one for me? Or reach the one. The next one for me, and I got it for her, and I reached it. I'm like, I don't know how they would have expected you to reach it. She's like, I don't know either, honey, but thank you. And I'm just like, you're welcome. I felt good about myself. I went on my day. You know what I mean? But there's some people where I'll go, hi, and they'll look at me like I said, give me your purse, bitch. And it's like, you know what I mean?
Do you really feel that?
Some days. Okay. No, literally, I've had people cross the street and clutch their purse in the process. Like they, you ever
That's
see those football
really
players?
Bad.
You ever see those football players switch the ball over when an attacker is coming at them? That they do that same shit. And that's oh shit,
bro.
Switch arms, cross the street. Like they're like, yo, what do you mean?
When I shave my head, my own family tells me they'd cross the street if they saw me coming.
Can I see that? Can you take your hat off? Okay.
Apparently, yeah.
Yeah,
see?
I see it. I mean,
I can't
say
see
that.
It. The hat does soften
the
you.
The hat softens
you. Have like you have a steely glare.
And what the fuck is that shit?
Scariest shit.
Oh my goodness.
Let's see it
I'm
again.
I'm just naturally evil looking, I guess. Like people just think I'm gonna punch them or some shit.
I wouldn't go that far and say you're evil.
I wouldn't say
that's
that.
That's a little like.
But like I don't know. People just I don't know.
Over the line.
The hat just kind of seems to. More friendly looking, I guess.
Yeah, It does.
My own grandma used to tell me that shit. Wow. Uh-huh. Well, thanks, grandma.
Oh my gosh, there's another one? I thought it was done. Oh my gosh, okay. Like, I'm supposed to, like, what kind of a host am I? I'm supposed to be getting my guests influenced by, what was this one?
Tequila.
This was some tequila. I think it was Jose Cuervo?
Yeah.
Some Jose Cuervo gold.
He's got quite
gold. Gold is, like, my favorite. I can't drink anything but gold.
Gold is smooth. Yeah, honestly, that's it's why
I drink it. I can't drink tequila.
No, this is okay, like, especially frozen.
I'm going to be rowdy. I have a sombrero. I need a bigger one to fit my head for next Cinco de Mayo. You know what's boss? My dad's birthday is Cinco de Mayo.
Yo, that's pretty sick.
So, like, if he had any Latin friends, like, he'd have a birthday party every single year. Pinata, you know what I mean? And, like,
chill.
You know what sucks? I had a buddy growing up whose birthday was Christmas.
Wow.
Wow, that's terrible. Wait, you didn't even cheers me on my last four.
Wow.
Did you see that?
Damn.
I have to call it out. I call it as I see it.
I got called out. Oof.
He's like, I gotta do this one, next one so quickly. Oh, no.
Oh, gosh.
No, it's good. Oh, fantastic. Gosh. It needs a lemon. Like, it definitely, like, is one of those drinks that needs, like, a little something. The salt lemon
needs
combo?
A peach mango.
No, but the salt lemon combo, like, that literally kills all tequila flavor.
Y'all see my face right now, ladies and gentlemen?
Yeah, right there, bro.
I'm sorry, Vlad.
No, you're not. I think you're getting a degree of joy out of this.
No, I think you haven't. You're
I'm good. I'm good.
You're fine.
I'm getting like, a degree of joy out of this.
You're the same exact, you know, just a little more enhanced.
Mm-hmm. Now, I got to be careful who I invite to my show. Some people want to get me high, and some people might be influencing me getting drunk.
Case in point A.
You know what I mean?
Case in point B.
But it's all good because you're getting some candid conversations.
Now I feel like I got to roll.
Oh, God.
But you know what? Everyone's got their vice. Let's talk about this. Everyone's got their vice.
Oh, my gosh,
it doesn't matter. I don't give a shit if you're an eater, you overeat, you have too much sex, you know.
I'm like 0 for 2 right now.
You know what I mean? No, but you know what I mean. It's like you... Everyone's got their thing. Everyone's got their clutch.
It's true.
Whether it's, like, I don't care if it's... Well, I care if it's heroin.
Okay,
like,
cool.
I would say, like, I don't care if it's weed or drinking or smoke, you know? Like, everyone, and so I accept people. That's been a big, big lesson. Like,
yeah, acceptance.
Accepting people as they are, not as you want them to be.
Oh my gosh, say it again.
Accepting people as you are, not as you want them to be, because that fucks everything up.
Yep.
It destroys relationships. It literally destroys everything. Do not project yourself onto others.
No, don't do it, because everybody has their own path.
Everybody.
Everybody has their own.
So walk your own, right? Like.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're rolling a blunt on this side, on the left-hand side.
It's legal, why not? Okay, why not?
If you understand how frequently people cope by projecting, that you would learn to take absolutely nothing seriously. Absolutely nothing.
Yeah, that just finished my night. That just finished my night. I realized what I was doing and what I was getting myself into.
What?
But hey.
Projecting.
With the blunt?
Wait, what?
Yeah. The blunt.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you hear what I just said, though? If you understand how frequently people cope by projecting, you would learn to take absolutely nothing personally.
That's deep. I heard it the first time, but the second time it resonated.
I know. The first time I knew it didn't, and that's why I had to repeat it.
I
felt you feel it, but not feel it.
Yeah, no, it's like how I have to repeat my name whenever I'm talking to anybody. Like, oh, what does that mean? Divine achievements bring life's opportunity, carrying knowledge. Huh? Divine achievements bring life's opportunity carrying knowledge. Dublock.
That's amazing.
Things happen to teach those willing to learn.
You expect motherfuckers to get that the first time you say it that motherfucking fast.
I sometimes say that fast on purpose to catch their attention because I know they're not listening, but you know.
And
you
don't expect a, huh? Hey.
Well, he said he got a lot of
hints. I got a lot of hints.
Maybe you should
right?
Adjust the way that you
slow down.
Yeah, bro.
So they can just get to know.
You know what? Delivery is everything.
It is.
When you're trying to send a message to someone, it does
control their day. Like, are they having a good day?
Yes.
Are they feeling bad?
Yes.
Are they feeling upset? Are they, you know what I mean? You have to gauge that first. And then, wait, where was I? I lost it.
Engaging, trying to figure out how to go for with someone.
Oh, delivery. And then when you deliver it, deliver that message, make sure you deliver it in a pretty package in, like, the best way possible. So one of my like, big mentors in life told me one time, before you tell someone bad news, tell them good news first. Or start it off well. Right? Like, it's all about just communicating, the vibes you pick up. Like, are you following?
Yeah. Yeah, I hear what you're saying.
You're wearing a great pair of shoes. I love them. Where'd you get them? By the way, Dad died.
No. I don't
mean
material things.
Oh, man.
That's her.
If you didn't know him by now,
and you know what? Now I know. No,
you
but
will
I know.
Never, ever,
I
ever
knew.
Know him.
I knew. I get it.
I'm just saying.
No. Oh.
He just has to go like left field, kind of.
Yep.
But like, I appreciate it. I understand it.
Oh my goodness.
I respect it.
Oh.
I have to.
That's why I said he had to.
If I didn't do it, it wouldn't.
That
be
was my
me.
Response. Is he had.
Fox just shaking his head.
That's all I can do right now, bro. Like, you're giving me mad jokes. So, we got to talk about the shows again because you never know who's tuning in when. We have 5 shows, actually, now that are running right now. We have Daddy Daughter Time that happens on Mondays at 5.
Aww,
which is
yeah.
fucking
that's
adorable.
So sweet.
Yeah.
I've never seen that, but maybe I'll tune in.
Yeah, we didn't get this week's episode done because Miss Thing has her drawing and stuff that she's doing, so we kind of didn't get it down, and plus we weren't exactly sure when we were going to like be able to go live, so, you know, that didn't happen. But then we got this show on Wednesdays, Candid Conversations, where we talk to interesting people about interesting things. It's the best way for me to describe it.
Today was just kind of a bunch of drunk stone chatter.
No, but there was quite a... We did hit some topics.
We talked about some stuff that people, like, the depression.
Some serious shit.
Depression.
Yeah,
that was a good topic. You know what I mean?
Thank you, Victoria. Appreciate that.
That's the thing. You're sometimes going to have to watch the whole show to get any good thing out of it because, you know, we crack jokes. We had a good, like, there's a good segment there for, like, 2 minutes where
laughed.
We were just laughing.
We weren't even laughing at
I don't even remember right now.
Oh, how you passed the blunt.
Oh, yeah, with the fucking...
You moved it up?
Oh, yeah. You moved your hand up. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my goodness.
Motherfucker passed me a fucking heater.
I would, like, that's why I was hesitant to even pass it in the first place. Did you not see me stop over the ashtray? I was going to out it. I'm just like, nah, okay, he's reaching for it. I'm like, all right, if he can fit it. I'm like, but wait, my hands are in the way. Oh, no, shit. Like, all of this is happening in my head as, like, I'm reaching for it. Like, I'm reaching to pass you the blunt.
Here, bro.
Yeah. Oh, what the fuck ever, bro? That's not happening. I'm better off you throw the damn thing.
Here, I have pincers.
I'm better off with you throwing it. Oh, my gosh. This is crazy. Well, dart it at me? Okay.
Like, I'll catch it and then flip it up quick before it burns.
Oh, man. Yeah, I got static in my beard.
Is that it?
That's got to be what it is.
100%, bro. You gotta shave it.
I don't know about
shave
that.
It for the
baby, listen,
shave it for entertainment.
Would you shave yours?
I have like a baby face. It's not happening, bro.
I've been considering shaving mine, but I don't think I'm going to.
Yeah, I can't do a shaved whole.
We should make a bet one time that has our beards.
Oh, man. You see, he's thinking already. I could tell. Yeah.
Something sport related.
I figured it was gonna be that. I don't even bother trying with the whole Maple Leafs and the Stanley Cup because
maybe the next Pittsburgh Toronto game.
Never going to win.
Pittsburgh Toronto game.
The next Pittsburgh Toronto game.
Whoever wins goes babyface.
Whoever wins, the other guy's
gotta
shave.
The other guy's gotta shave.
Yeah, like if Pittsburgh wins the game. The Toronto fans gotta shave.
Right. I also have to run this by my wife and Jer because I have an image to maintain. I do. As vain as it sounds.
It's not vain.
You know what I mean? I have to.
It's committal.
Yeah. I'm telling you, bro, I lose like 10 years when this beard
Please,
is gone. Easily.
Jenny, allow this to happen.
Well, she's like, wait, why should I wait till then? Maybe I'll bet him the next fucking Boston Toronto game.
Yo!
Oh my
god. Jenny,
gosh.
Bet him for the next Boston Toronto game. Whichever game comes up, Block's gotta bet. And I got your back. If Boston loses, I'll shave my beard. So,
was it just?
Wow.
So I'll put it up for next time Toronto plays either team.
Okay. All right. We'll see. Oh man. Honestly, shaving it off.
I honestly feel like it's like your boy. Like I don't care who you are. There needs to be some scruff on your face. Personally.
See?
So when you look at a guy without it, you're like,
you don't want to do it.
I have a grown and mature. Like,
you just look at them and you're like,
You know what I mean? It's not that I don't want to do it. It's just like
it doesn't
like,
work.
Yeah, it's just it's hard, bro.
It's a hard no.
It's hard to bet something like that because I know what I have to lose. You know what I mean? Like I have.
So what I'm hearing here is you have no faith in the Toronto Maple Leafs.
No, I never said I have no faith in the Toronto Maple Leafs. As a matter of fact, I wouldn't be surprised. Like, fuck, Jenny, tag the Toronto Maple Leafs to this. Fuck it, whatever.
You have no faith in the Maple Leafs.
Oh, fuck it, whatever. Find a way to tag the Toronto Maple Leafs to this shit, and we'll go. Like, we'll do it, whatever. Might as well tag the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Boston Bruins as well.
What was the Vegas team?
No.
You want to put Vegas in there? No, yeah. I can't throw too many games in the Leafs.
Yeah,
this guy's like, yo, like
that. I'm sitting here like, wait a minute, hold on.
These are the top teams.
Hold up.
Like, whose side are you on here right now? I feel like an oven because of the damn tequila. I'm good, though.
You'll feel great.
Oh, I feel excellent.
You'll literally wake up tomorrow and be like, first of all, you're going to have maybe a wild night. I don't know. But you might just, like, feel great all night. And then you might wake up. Okay. I'm still feeling okay. Like, I just don't get a hangover off tequila.
The worst part about it is, like, she said it, and I'd already thought it. And
I was just saying exactly what everyone thinks.
Oh, my goodness. Look at this. Like,
I was nowhere near that in my train of thought.
I'm glad you
weren't. Exclude me
fine.
From Block's night. Please. We good?
Oh,
I ain't thinking about that, bro. Once, you know, we homies, but once I leave. That's cool.
Alright, cool. Yeah, don't worry. I know how to contain myself. Okay. Thanks for the support, though. Thanks for the support. I appreciate it. You know what I mean?
Not on my mind. List of things not on my mind. That.
But you
things not on my mind. That. No, you're not lying. You're speaking the truth. It's just like there's certain things that like we guys don't really.
Can we talk about everything?
Can we talk about those stereotypes for a second?
Yes, let's talk about those.
We talk about everything.
I have recently discovered this in conversations, but y'all females talk about everything.
Everything.
But hold on, that's after.
Like down to everything.
That's after 20 years. Of being told that we dudes talk about everything. You know what dudes talk about in the fucking locker room?
They literally don't talk
about. We talk
about
sports or
yeah.
We don't talk.
Yeah.
Like, we're like, oh, yeah, fucking, you know, we don't establish eye contact with people when we're in bathrooms and gossip spots.
We don't gossip. Yeah. We talk about all the intimate details of little things you guys don't talk about.
See, we don't talk about that shit. Like.
I haven't bet on hockey since 2008. Nope. Jenny.
You can't even try? Not this one time.
Damn it.
No, 2008. I remember 2008.
What was 2008?
I don't know. I remember
Jenny, what was 2008?
Wait, what was 2008? Because I remember 2011 was the year that before the fucking season started, she's like, oh yeah, Boston's going to win this one. And I'm like, what are you talking about?
And they won?
Boston won that shit.
Yeah.
Boston won it so nice. And they booted the Leafs in the second.
Knew.
The least of like the first or second round.
Was that when they had Tim Thomas in that?
Tim Thomas, yeah.
I fucking hated him. He was the worst goalie ever.
No, he wasn't because he won the fucking Stanley Cup.
Because he was fat and out of shape.
But he won the Stanley Cup.
He would just fall and be in the way of things.
But he won the Stanley Cup.
It was like saying that Shaq was an amazing athlete.
While winning the World Cup.
Was Shaq an amazing athlete?
Well, winning the NBA championship. Okay.
Shaq was naturally gifted in ways that made him way bigger.
And being able to win the NBA championship.
Hurting people.
And winning the NBA championship.
That's your goal today is be huge.
Yeah. If I was that big and I didn't win an NBA championship, I would consider my life a failure.
Okay, that makes sense.
Like, I'd be like, what am I going to do with my life? Obviously,
bro, I've had two people,
the NBA.
I've had two people just hand their title over to me and say, here, take a picture with this. So, like, I don't have to worry about much right now.
Why didn't he become, like, a football? Like, he obviously had a knack for basketball.
Because he was not fast.
But
in football, you can you can do certain things.
His height would be a disadvantage.
But you can do certain things with that. That's also an advantage in some.
To block in football, you need to be short and big.
Yeah.
And he's huge.
And he would have been too tall. Like, he would have been, like, to his
big.
Chest. Like,
yeah.
He could have stood.
He was, like, 7 foot.
Yeah.
Like that.
That's kind of fucked up. Like, imagine just.
He would, like, trip
up,
over
like,
people.
Beside him. Like,
oh, my gosh.
Holy.
Like, God. I'm 6'3, and he'd make me look like a dwarf.
I saw a picture of him, and I think it was his wife or his girlfriend or something.
Oh, my gosh. How does she How does she take, like.
I think about that all
like,
the time.
It must be, like passing a football every time. <or something. laughs>
Wow.
I'm sorry, but this is where we speak what we feel. This is true. He went there and beyond. That's the moniker.
Yo, she was like, her head was like just over his waist.
Like,
and I'm just like.
I saw like a chipmunk like sucking or like eating something and it was like this.
Eating a banana.
Yeah. Like
oh my God.
Something like that. And it was just like a tall guy and a short ass girl. And it was just like, that was the meme. That was it.
Like, oh no. Like, ow. Ouch. Ouch.
Broken in.
Ouch.
Toronto beat Boston, and I had to. Oh my gosh. It was only three jerseys. I don't know what you're talking about. What happened was we. Oh my gosh. I feel bad about this now because, like, the streak Boston was on, I never thought it was going to happen.
What did you do?
I bet on Toronto.
Oof.
And,
Boston's amazing though. I like that.
We had
the bullies.
We had this bet, and it was if Boston won, I don't remember what I had to do for her, but I had to do something for her.
What did you do?
And
you didn't do it?
No. If Toronto won, she had to buy me these like jerseys because like
that was the bet.
That
was essentially the
bet. That was essentially the bet. So you know what I mean. So then two twos, fucking. Toronto wins the game, and I'm just like, it was the last game Toronto won from then to like 2016.
Wow.
What
year is this?
2008.
Okay. Yeah, they were losers for a long time.
It wasn't even that they were losers, but the fact that there were certain teams that they lost to in tremendous fashion, and they made the playoffs. So once they make the playoffs, they can't be considered losers. They've made the playoffs in the last 5 years.
True.
Stop being.
But how hard is that? How many? Let's talk about the numbers. Like how many teams get
roach,
in?
Okay. Stop being snot roach.
They made it in 1 year that has the biggest asterisk beside it because it was a strike year.
I understand that.
So we can just wipe that one off the mattering board.
Not necessarily, but okay.
The mattering.
And
board.
Then yes, okay.
That.
Last year
I'm
they had an okay team because they have Babcock now. And now they're already talking about possibly getting rid of Babcock.
Oh, I thought they were going to get rid of him last year.
Because the head office at Toronto likes to shoot themselves in the fucking foot.
No, but I literally thought they were going to get rid of him last year.
And then Babcock's going to bring them to the finals, and then they're going to win.
Why the fuck would Babcock focus on them if they're talking about getting rid of him already?
He doesn't give a shit.
He's not going to worry about building.
He's literally
he's not going to worry about building the team now.
He's not interested.
He's one of the best coaches in the fucking league.
This is true.
Guarantee you, he's already reaching out to other people saying they have whispers.
They're being
Where do you want me to go? He's not going to focus on building this fucking team.
He hasn't
Congrats,
been.
What he did in the last year or
he
two,
hasn't
that's
been
where he
though.
Stops.
But he hasn't been. He's tried, but he hasn't really been.
He built a playoff team.
He probably has always been uninterested in
And now he's
Toronto.
Not going to worry about what Excel in the past.
Let's just put it out there.
He's already hearing whispers. Why would he invest his time? He's going to get his money and be like, fuck you guys.
But Kawhi came here to win the championship knowing that he had no intention of staying.
I know.
He knew he had no intention of staying, but he still helped them win the championship.
Because he did what
You know what people in the league consider Toronto, bro? Or did, at least until Babcock came.
A lot.
It was the retirement home, bro. Yeah. It was the team. It was the legacy team that everybody wanted to play for when you were in your last season or two of hockey. You tried to get into the Leafs so you could say you played for one of the original six and such a franchise team. It's never been a cup team. Not for 60 years, bro.
Because of people who have a similar perspective.
He's not wrong, though. I have to give it, like,
I find it hard to believe that they would win, as they would earn as much money as they do without having a formula of success in some market.
It's been proven that they have some of the most loyal fans.
That's all it is.
And until
it's just like
that dwindles, why would they try anything different?
It's dwindling. And they are. The team is much younger than... Like, from the night...
They're so young. Last year, I looked at them, I was like, these kids are fucking kids.
If you look at it
from... Every one of them.
All right, how about that bet? We gotta shave if the Leafs make it to the cup, I'll shave.
Wow, that's actually, like, pretty noble. They'll probably
make
it.
Make it to the cup?
They gotta, yeah, you say that they...
Okay. They will. They probably will.
They're gonna win it, just gotta make it to the
cup. They're gonna make it there. To the...
Then I'll get rid of it.
Game one, okay. Okay.
The night that they put their feet on that ice, I'll shave it.
I'll take that. Well, that means I'd have to shave if they don't make the cup.
I think you're gonna
only if they don't make it in the Pens.
He's kind of cornering you here. Like, you're
only if they don't make it in the Pens do.
The Pens, like, don't often make it.
To the cup?
Do they?
They've been there more recently than the Leafs have.
No.
They just got over a back-to-back wins 2 years ago.
He looked. Did you not see his head spin, though? Did you see his head spin? Just like. What are you talking
about? All good, but like, I was just like, wait, what? I didn't think that.
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah,
I
was like 2 years
ago.
In my entire life, I'm one.
Because of Crosby, he was there. Like,
I can say that. My entire time being a Pens fan, I've watched them win the cup back-to-back twice, plus multiple other cups in between.
I've met Sidney. Like, he's not that... He was a dick back then. Like, a big, huge asshole.
I think he's allowed to be.
No, but back in the day, in the locker room and stuff, like, people, like, did not like this kid. I'm literally...
If I was that good, I don't think anybody would like me. There's people who don't like me. A lot of people who don't like me, because I'm good at what I do. And I do it very well.
And it irritates their demons or something?
Oh, my God. It stirs them up. It's like,
that's
I
want
to be able to do
that's
that.
That's gross. And that's not, like, it's just not what you want. You want to be able to. I literally believe in sharing, like, that, like, success. Like, I want more people to be where, you know what I mean? Like, let's level people up. Like, it's not a handout. It's like a hand up.
Yeah.
Help you out. Right? Like,
straight up. That's
how I think.
It's a positive mentality to have.
It's very naive, some people say, but I don't really care. Like,
no, you just got to be mindful of who you're trying to level up, because some people try to level up at your expense. And, like, it's like, okay, they'll see that you're willing to offer them $10, but then they'll ask you for 15.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's like, okay, no, we can't work like that. I told you 10 is all I can offer, you know what I mean?
That's
like,
right. Well, I mean, that's business.
Yeah, that's...
It's straight up.
Yeah. Well, you know what I mean?
I feel like the term capitalism fits here.
Those are just marginal numbers, right. Obviously. But, like, that adds up.
Fuck capitalism.
Fuck it. Who's this? This is your daughter.
That's my son. I don't know. He won't let us cut his hair.
That's your son?
Yeah, he won't let us cut his hair. Like, at
okay,
all.
Okay, yeah, now I see it. Like, I wasn't looking very close. Also, smoked weed for the first time in, like, 3 years.
Oh my goodness, we
broke
a streak.
It was just, no, it wasn't like I didn't avoid it for a reason. I just, like, haven't really wanted to.
Oh, okay.
But I also took, like, a tiny, like, I'm fine.
Okay.
Drank a lot more influence of tequila tonight than the 2 tiny pops I took.
I think I'm fine until I stand up.
I don't know, when you stand up, you'll be like, woo! But you also.
Oh.
Yeah.
We about to have a marathon show because Block can't stand up to turn this shit off.
Oh, man. I think we've been
what
on.
What time
for, like,
is it? Yeah, we've been on
like
for
it's
a bit.
9 o'clock right
9
now.
9 o'clock. Holy shit.
Yeah, so I've been on for like an hour and a half.
How long were we on last time?
I think we were on for like
two
hours.
Okay, so yeah.
Yeah.
We're here. So we've arrived.
We're here. Thing. We're high. Get used to it.
Yeah. Well, Topsy Kretz and Rose Terrell are watching with you. What up, Topsy? Topsy! good people.
She's literally the best people.
Like, I don't know, like...
I don't know anyone, like, I've met people like her, but I think she's very, like...
The only person that I've met like that amazing. That was willing to prepare food the way she does for people that came over was, like, I married her. You know, I was like, shit, I was like, what do you mean you coming out with a platter and fucking, a platter of cheese and crackers? What's wrong with you? Okay, I'll take some of those. And you got the meat platter? Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I got, there was, Topsy! There was a meat platter! Hold on a second! Wait a minute!
Hang on.
It's all good. It's all good. Guess we got that next time. But, no, but, like, even the day my girl brings a crock pot of, like, a slow cooker, and there's, like, turkey in there and stuffing in there and vegetables in there and all of that, I'm just like,
you're like, shh, yes, please.
Yo, hook a brother up, yo. Like, it was, like, the one time, the missus made me this, Triscuits, yeah. It was Triscuits with chicken, cheese, sour cream, cheese, and what else? Yeah. Sour cream, and I don't know if it had peppers on it.
Yo, can I have a cigarette, please? I literally will return them. They're just, like, you know what I mean?
But it was such, like, it was...
I need one down here. So I'm going outside in the cold. I'm sorry.
No worries, no worries. It was such a divine meal, bro.
He's like, just thinking about the memories. He's just like
hungry.
Like he literally just like stops talking half sentence, and he's just like, it was like. Like he's tasting it in his mind right now.
Self-soothing.
Yeah. Can you make that again?
Like, oh. Yeah,
honestly,
God.
If we had the things for it, I'd ask her to do it. But you know what? Like, I remember fucking. I went over to Stats one time. And he,
can we not have this conversation right now? I'm really baked.
Okay.
I will, like, buy out a McDonald's on the way home.
Bro, I remember one time I was this high. If not, yeah, around this level. And we went to fucking McDonald's. I dropped, like, $40 just on fucking, like, I got a meal and I got a side. And I upsized the meal.
You ever wake up in the morning and see a McDonald's receipt after drinking?
Oh.
And you don't realize just how much you spent, and you're like, I just spent like $80 motherfucking dollars at McDonald's. How is that possible?
Holy shit, like, what do you buy? Like,
why do I have, I did not need 6 Big Macs. McDonald's people, if you see a drunk dude coming in and order 6 Big Macs, say no, you don't need that.
You don't need that.
Like, why do I did not need all that drinks? How did I get it all home? Like, that's a lot of shit.
Wow, bro.
Like, there's a lot of bags. I'm home with it, though, and I spent that money, and there's no food left over. I'm going,
you ate it all.
I'm going, that's one big-ass receipt.
That's serious, bro. That's mad. I'm looking at the meters. So what y'all looking at is the new setup right there. I'm sure you see the screens. I should have, like, something designed on them to promote the Expose the North. But I got my hat. So, Expose the North. How you doing? You can order that, $35. You can order a t-shirt as well. No, not bad. $25 for the t-shirt, $35 for the hat. I mean, you know what I mean? Help me promote us.
Merch.
Exactly.
It's one of my categories. Merchandise.
Okay. That's what's up. I need to do another. Oh, I don't know if you're going to smoke that.
I'm
okay.
Good.
Yeah. So, what else we got to talk about? Hockey started, basketball started. Which one is more beneficial for the country, hockey or basketball?
Hockey.
Is that because there's more teams?
Probably nationally supported.
No.
Why is that?
It's the story of Canada.
It's nationally supported.
When you think of, like, the growing up Canadian story, it's playing on the pond, wanting to be a hockey player one day.
Nationally supported.
My real Canadian remix, I put. I am a real Canadian. I like scrambled eggs and bacon. I play street hockey with my friends. I will not fight. I'll do what's right. Yeah.
When you think Canada, you don't think necessarily basketball shoes.
You should now.
You should, but it was invented in Canada.
Think about the stereotype, bro.
It was invented in Canada.
We go to war with hockey sticks. That's a stereotype.
You know what I mean?
It was invented here.
Yes, that's true.
Yeah. So it's about, like, so I think both were invented here.
No, hockey dates back long before Canada.
That's
was
more like
thing.
A European kind of thing. Like, everyone's just Sweden.
It's always had a version. Like, it wasn't necessarily on ice, but it's always had a version of it. Hit a stick.
Road
hit
hockey,
a, hit something
street
to a hole.
Hockey, roller hockey.
It's kind
of
an evolved sport.
Hockeys, right?
Okay.
I don't know where.
I know someone who wins the championship in roller hockey every year.
Really?
Yeah. I'll shout him out. Brett Leggett.
Okay.
He's not here, but like every year just wins. Like, he goes to Europe, plays in like wherever, and he wins. He's one of my best friends. He owns like a bunch of car dealerships in Burlington if you ever need a car.
Okay.
The Leggett Auto Group. Little shameless plug for my friend. Like, really good friend. He hooked up a lot of my
friends.
I've
heard of the Leggett name. Actually, one of the.
They're successful guys.
One of the principals.
I like seeing that.
One of the principals at a school at Pickering High when I went there was the vice principal was Mr. Leggett. I don't remember his first name.
Probably like his grandfather.
No, he would have been like a uncle, cousin kind of.
Maybe.
Age.
Well, they're a big family.
Yeah.
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 They're like, they have like maybe 15 to 30 dealerships like all over.
Oh, shit.
They're not like tiny.
Yeah, I think there's a whole bunch by that name in Burlington. Over on the service road area. Or no, maybe something.
There's like Leggett, Cadillac, Pontiac, whatever.
I was literally just about to ask what brand.
There's Leggett Acura, there's Leggett, there's literally Leggett everything.
Okay.
BMW, there's a Volkswagen, there's like a Leggett whatever you want. Capitalism, however,
these
guys are smaller town. Like, my friend just bought a Corvette off one of my other friends.
You see what I mean? Like,
you gotta make those connections.
You see what I mean?
He bought it in cash, and it was like a lot less than he would have paid not in cash.
Don't you love when you get showed up on your own show and shit?
Am I showing you up?
No, I'm playing. It's all good. No, honestly, this show's about making the kind of good connections.
Yeah,
like,
let's
you know what I mean? And that's what's happening right now. Like,
capitalism.
He's not. He, like, they're small town guys.
But
it
encourages
small town people. No, but these are small town people that took a group of people, hired them, and was like, let's build something.
Exactly. That's fire.
Right?
That's
so I look
capitalism.
At that, but I also look at that as entrepreneurship.
Successful capitalism.
No, entrepreneurship is different than like, when you're an entrepreneur, you're just a hustler. You're hustling, you're getting your own client, you're doing your own stuff. You're going door to door, you're starting, like, from literally wherever you need to start.
Working at a grocery
store. I respect that. Do you not respect that?
I don't hate on somebody for being
building
successful in the society we're forced to live in.
He just found an like a little niche.
People adapt.
Yeah.
You need to survive.
And and that's why, so like, to be honest, like, I'm all about the entrepreneur. Like, so what I do is I coach entrepreneurs. They don't necessarily know the business side of things, but they have mad ideas.
Okay.
Idea, you know what I mean? Like, they're like, you guys spit rhymes and you have ideas and you say what you need to say.
Yeah.
They have ideas about, let's make this better, or let's do this better, or let's add to this. Like, let's rebel against society, but in like a little bit of a different way. Like, let's make it better.
Yeah.
So that's, I don't know. Some of my friends built like some of the first, you know how like there's passwords and they're annoying? You have to remember 800 passwords. They built like this one password kind of like key lock thing that now Google bought that blew them up. But they were literally nobodies from Kitchener doing their thing in Kitchener. You know what
well,
I mean?
There's a huge tech industry out there.
There is, but these guys, like, literally they found
huge.
A problem.
Isn't our, like, isn't Kitchener, like, our Silicon Valley?
Yeah, it's our Silicon Valley.
It is?
Yeah.
But these guys were not, they were, like, living in, you know
I drive by signs, it's just, like, Google headquarters.
Yeah,
fucking,
now,
like, all these
now, but it wasn't
businesses.
Like that 5 years ago. So I watch this stuff. I watch how it comes from
Welland's
wherever.
Next.
Let's go up to
this
Canada.
Man says Welland's next. Bruh.
Just saying.
Bro, they're building a Holiday Inn out here.
Oh, y'all getting the Holiday Inn?
We're gonna have to build more than that, obviously.
What's up, Holiday Inn in Welland? Come on down. You can see our.
Was that song? It's like
nothing.
I'm chilling at the Holiday Inn.
You can see our.
Who
got a movie
that
theater,
again? Tell me why one person should travel to Welland. What's one thing for tourists to see?
It's
there's a lot of waterfront.
20 minutes of
there's a lot
Niagara
of cool water,
Falls.
But there's also cool waterfronts.
So
waterfront is excellent.
Hold on,
Merritt Island.
Literally, go you can see battleships across
nature,
the
if
way.
If you're interested in nature in any way, Merritt Island.
This man's way of saying come to Welland is because it's close to somewhere interesting to go.
No.
He just said it's close to Niagara Falls.
Well, no, I also said it because close to Merritt Island.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Do you want Merritt Island stories, or do you just want me to avoid that in general?
Incomplete.
You have Merritt Island stories, don't you?
Oh, bro, tons, man. I
okay.
Ran
do they happen
series?
During the day?
Day and night.
Oh, jeez. I'm not sure I want to hear them right now.
Yeah, I'd like to
know. No, we good. We good.
No. Third stories aren't like, you know, block
sure, they're
stories.
Wild? And they're
yeah.
Fun.
Yeah.
I have a lot of friends that are probably similar.
We used to punch some people out on those paths. That's all I'm saying.
See, bro, we can implicate ourselves on TV because people can use this
information. Statute of limitations.
Wow.
Are you hearing? Well, you're not hearing this. It's okay, ladies and gentlemen.
All right.
Statute of limitations. I'm good.
Yeah, I know. That was serious. Well, in that case,
okay.
Hey, it's your life. Go ahead.
No, I ain't telling them. I'm good. But that ain't even the only story, bro. Fucking junkies on. Welland's a hurting city right now.
Okay.
It would need a lot to attract the public. Like, a hotel is cool and all, but it's gonna be busy at, like, Christmas.
No, it'll be busy
when grandma
people
shows up and doesn't
want to
stay
home.
We host aquatic events annually.
It'll be busy when
people
want to go to Toronto.
Let's talk
and
about
Niagara.
That. Let's talk about that.
And want to be somewhere in the middle slash somewhere.
You
closer.
Host aquatic ship
yeah.
because of that little band show, right?
I guess if you want to call it that.
Whatever it is, where people go and sing and it floats in the water and it's all pretty and cool. It's literally like right beside a park where so many homeless people sleep.
That's sad.
Well, this is just a terrible news.
Why in the fuck?
Two viewpoints.
Does a city like Welland invest their money in dumbass shit like lights for a bridge and a floating stage when its number one problem is drugs and homelessness?
Bro, I spent a day dealing with more bullshit than any one man should. And it landed me barred from City Hall because they don't appreciate my knowledge base of what they should be doing compared to what they're actually doing. And when you hold someone accountable for their actions, they don't entirely appreciate it, especially when they're neglectful.
When I Welland was my city. This is where I hung out when I was 16, 17, 18, all those fun years.
What up, cuz?
I come back now, and I run into people that I used to know, and 50% homeless, 50, you know, like, probably 80% dealing with drug issues. And the other 20%, like, they just
isn't homelessness, like, it kind of stems from drug issues, yeah?
This city has absolutely deteriorated so many people.
I firmly believe
it destroys people.
Yes,
I would never move back to this
the
city.
The type of drug that they use
is meth?
Also dependent on the nature of complications they're going through.
Fentanyl's all over the city right now.
That's killed, like, a lot of people.
Welland's dirty.
Here's the problem that I have as a resident of the city. A lot of people focus on the negative, disregarding the positive that does exist. I mean,
to fentanyl,
like,
or?
No, the positive, like, the positive that exists. That exists within the city. I mean, like, they just rebuilt the skate park. That's showing some interest.
Revitalization.
Yeah. Like, they're building all over the city.
Do the homeless people sleep there?
Well, do they not?
I'm just wondering if it's, like, a cool shelter that they can sleep in and be
safe
at night.
It potentially could be, though.
Or they could have just taken that money and built the homeless people a shelter.
Well, they are
maybe hire some counselors.
Counselors.
They are building programs and projects with. Hold on, I would have.
No, I can tell.
Bless you.
I can tell you
bless
personally.
You again, one more bless you.
Wow, they are building.
Unless
they
hold on.
They are building housing units at the what's it called? Hope Center for homeless people to reside at, and they've also put a community garden outside of it, so, I mean, it's not to say they're not making an effort, and yes, the effort could be much more significant, but it's going to take the energies of more people to speak for these who can't speak for themselves.
Do you know what the Elijah House is?
No, I do not. Oh, yes, I do. Baby is deciding to move around instead of during the day. LOL. Okay, cool.
You know what the Elijah House is?
Yeah.
It works with, like, young moms and shit.
E-L-I-S-H-A?
Yeah.
Yeah, boy, that place is a problem.
Did you know that they rely 100% on donations?
I know the course of act, the conduct is not entirely something I could invest in.
What do you mean?
Oh, okay.
I've been through their process. Well, I actually went to start a process with them, and it didn't go as heartily as you would have expected it. It's a very invasive process or procedure. Very.
See, I've known people who had a completely different experience with it.
Are those people anything like me?
One is a fiery redhead who, like, yeah.
You know what's funny? My hair actually does go red in the summer if I am not wearing a hat. So,
wow.
But yeah, no, I found the place pretty good to work with. But then again, we were there kind of minimally. But did you know that all the services that they rely on to, like, help deal with so many young moms in the city is all, like, donation based? There's no city funding for that shit.
That's crazy.
They give out diapers, but they rely on donations and shit. That's fucked.
So in Burlington, that's not.
So you're saying, like, Walmart could have a bin or a barrel for these people and receive or make donations, but they don't?
I'm saying our tax dollars could maybe help.
But that's how
poor moms instead of building ban shells.
That's how it goes in Burlington. You get, like, a bunch of baby money.
He's like, he had to go with that angle.
No, I'm just saying. Like,
entertainment versus dying people.
Okay. Well, we're not putting entertainment versus dying people. Those people who are dying could go and take go into palliative care. And the people who are in need of financial reprieve can engage in self or other types of employment. Like,
you say that as if Welland has the best economy.
It doesn't have to be in Welland. There's St. Catharines, there's Thorold, there's Niagara Falls. Like, there's opportunities everywhere. I know someone who came here from Africa, and
there are less opportunities out here.
I know someone who came here from Africa. Yeah, there are opportunities.
Saying, like,
he came here from Africa, and he didn't have anything when he came over here except his clothes.
Think about what you're describing.
When he got over here, he actually ended up working until he could buy a vehicle. Once he bought his vehicle, he slept in that vehicle until he could afford an apartment.
Rental, yeah.
And now he's renting an apartment, and he's just doing his thing. Like, so it's the work ethic.
Okay, hold on, though. You say nothing here, go to another city. That's looking a single mom in the eyes and saying, there's nothing for you here, why don't you leave potentially your only support systems, which is what you would have here with your friends and your family, and go somewhere else and try it there.
Oh, you're still on that one.
Deep, though. True.
You're still on that one.
You're not wrong.
I don't like that shit.
Listen, I wrote an 18-page submission to the Social Assistance Review on how they could better improve the quality of the services they render to their clients. So if we want to talk about looking at people who... If
don't
we
worry
want to talk
about lights on a bridge.
If we want to talk about varying loading demographics stages and what we can do to improve the circumstances of any particular unfortunate cases, then yeah, there's a lot that can be done to change. If you take a percentage of the profit from the housing market, for example, and attribute it towards those who are homeless, and I'm talking like all housing markets, the whole fucking industry, right? Like Remax and Royal LePage, Realty 21, all of them, and take a percentage of their profits and attribute it towards the the homeless situation, then you'd have less of a situation. Like, if they were held to building, if they were held to a standard of where they had to build, or a percentage of their homes has to be for, like projects, low income, like housing projects, things of that nature, you know what I mean? Then we wouldn't have a homeless issue.
Well, we still would. It just wouldn't be as bad. A lot of our homeless issue stems from mental health and drug issues.
St. Catharines does not have a good economy. Same with Alberta.
You know what? St. Catharines, the economy of St. Catharines itself, horrible economy. Surrounding area, Jordan, even Niagara on the Lake, great
Virgil.
Economy.
Yeah, Niagara on the Lake has a very good...
But Beamsville, Grimsby, like...
It's okay, actually. There are quite a few...
I see help wanted signs all day, every day.
Let's talk corporate for a sec. So, because I've been in charge of growing businesses out in the Golden Horseshoe for 9 years of my career, I'd say.
Dropping bombs.
And I cover Oakville to Niagara Falls, the border. That's my territory. So when my boss says focus on Oakville, Burlington, Hamilton, and says spend 1 day between Stony Creek, the end of Stony Creek, before all, you know, like you see all the like Red Yorks and the Fabrice and you see all the fucking big buildings, right? Past there, he's like spend there 1 day a week, 1 day a month, 1 day every couple months, and it just gets progressively larger. To me, that shows there's not a lot of industry out here. Mm. And therefore, there's not a lot of economy out here and not a lot of jobs. And it's unfortunate. It's a large area of space.
Well, there is one booming industry out here right now, and it's the weed market.
And there's no jobs unless you go out of town. If you go
that is right.
before it max,
yeah.
you are taking home at least $1,000 a month. Okay. Mm-hmm. If you go to Fort McMurray, you're
like
taking
Fort
home
McMurray,
at least $1,000 a month.
I mean, okay, so I don't even want to shamelessly plug. I used to work in the industrial industry.
Promote yourself, Joe.
No, it's not a promotion. It's a career thing. So I'm just saying, I saw the windmill, the Airbuses, all the different industries broken down in a report of, like, how they were doing versus how other industries are doing, right? So when it came to oil and gas, there was definitely a boom for a while. Now there's not necessarily that boom, and now a lot of people who have those jobs come to Ontario, which is, like, my buddy and I from Calgary used to make jokes, like, people coming to Ontario for oil and gas jobs, like, we used to be like, what, how the fuck is that happening? But in that world, there's such a, like, boom, bust, so you're either making a lot of money in a short amount of time, and you hit that uptrend, or you're just literally, you can't get a home for, like, anything. Like, everything's so bad out there now. Like, go out there now. Back in maybe 5 years ago, 7 years ago.
I'm good. I'll be middle class here.
Yeah, I got enough problems where I'm at. I got enough issues where I'm at. I ain't even trying to...
I know the name of the people I gotta pay my bills to.
You know what I mean? I know the people that are responsible for this property and how to hold them accountable, and I built a bit of a repertoire, so to speak, for my person, so... You know what I mean? They know who they're dealing with and what they're getting, and I know what I'm looking for before I move. Like, when I came down here, I wasn't sure what I was looking for, and I've heard a lot of negative about where I am, but I've changed a good percentage of what it was.
Yeah.
So, you know what I mean?
That's all you can wish to be is, like, that change, right?
That's all I can, you know what I mean? Like, from the property overall, the standards of the property have been, like, they've been elevated and they've been held accountable for the last several years. Like, that's all we can really do, you know what I mean? Hold whoever it is that's responsible for, like, our properties, our estates, our laws, our systems. We have to hold them accountable for what they're doing. Like, say you voted, you had your say. If you didn't win, then you have to look at the person who is, you know, in the position that, you know what I mean, in that position that can make the change, and you have to hold them accountable for the necessary change. And if they're making a change that you don't like, you You have to rally the people and get them, get a petition, get it signed, get them to speak to the member of the parliament or provincial parliament, whichever entity is responsible for that law or legislation, and speak to them about it, because change can be made. I myself have changed legislation, so I know change can be made. And there's a lot of people who don't believe it, but I've seen it with my own eyes.
That's happen. The slowest way possible, though.
That's okay. That's one of the most significant ways to do it. But
look around the world right now. Oh. That's the way to do it.
What? Just get
revolt.
A
whole. Everyone's just revolting right now.
I get that.
I'm just saying.
Okay.
Power in numbers.
And if every one of the people who was in that revolt signed the petition that was passed around, are you saying it wouldn't even be more successful?
I think the revolt would be more successful.
Are you telling me that it wouldn't be more significant?
I think the revolt is more significant.
Are you telling me that it wouldn't be more reasonable?
The revolt is definitely not as reasonable as your idea.
Okay, and it's not. It's going to cost a little bit more, too, if the revolt results in any damages.
Lots of damages.
Oh, the revolt's definitely resulting in damages.
Exactly my point. So all that energy could have been put towards, like, if I as a minister of anything see 3-4 million people outside of my offices with,
a lot of
know,
them don't give a shit, though.
With, you know what I mean, picket, like, signatures on form, like holding up fucking clipboards with forms and all that shit. Like, I have to acknowledge it. It has to be acknowledged.
But you also have to acknowledge it if they're like throwing rocks at your windows and shit.
Of course. And you'll probably acknowledge it faster.
Much faster.
But then, you know what I mean? You have the complication of having to compensate.
Hold on, wait. I think
and
I should say,
arrest,
I don't endorse this actions in Canada.
It's just a upheaval, right? Like, you have to, like, have police officers out there, and they're charging people, and, like, that results in other shit. Like, it's, like, you have to think about all of that, and it's, like, why pick a scab so fucking hard? Like, why don't you just attack it?
The states need to
intellectually, or, like, a different, in, like, a bit of a different manner.
Guns.
Yeah.
They need it in the states, but there's too many guns.
That's right. So, don't endorse
it in Canada. Like, we're safe.
Yeah.
But I said I don't endorse these actions in Canada. But
we're good.
It seems to be working in certain places.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's why
is
I said
it working?
And they're all trying to cop a cap.
Is it working or are things getting worse in those places? Because there's more racism towards the people revolting or this or that or this or that. Like, I feel like overall, if you look at a bird's eye view of the situation, it might make it worse.
I don't know.
Just
I
saying.
Mean, when you've got, like, a lot of these places, like, it's like they're smaller countries, so they'll have 60% of the fucking population, almost, it seems, in the streets. Like, there's millions and millions and millions of people in the streets for these things.
Yeah.
That's how you know that, like,
but that's like
shit
how,
needs to change.
But corruption also always remains. Like, for some reason, remember, like the Arab Spring, and people were lighting shit on fire and going all crazy?
I think,
like,
that was great.
And they did a good, like, you know, it was like a revolution
I think
in
that was
Egypt
great.
And, like, where else did they do it? They did it in a couple places.
They've been doing
right?
it all over the
yeah.
world. For
yeah,
the
but
last
but they don't
years,
win.
Then.
So it's like, what's the system that's gonna make you win, right? Like,
no.
is it equal?
Some
well,
systems
they,
have
they got
some systems are rigged to not, like, it doesn't matter how much you revolt. Literally, people are dying in thousands
okay,
a day.
Look at it this way,
right?
Look at
thousands
it this way.
A day,
look
not
at it this
100.
Way. Every country that's at war right now is one that doesn't have a central American centralized bank.
Agree. Or they owe money
no,
to the IMF.
Like, oh, you mean countries that
international
the states is hostile
monetary
with.
Funds,
yes.
right? Like
yes.
IMF or
yes.
there's a couple different agencies that are like global banks. The IMF is the biggest one.
Yeah.
International Monetary
or
Fund,
they are
which they take debts from China. Like, they take all sorts of, like, they have, they're their own political entity, but they're, like, Interpol.
Pay attention to Saudi Arabia, bro.
Dude, that's what my dad says all the time.
Pay attention to Saudi Arabia.
Like, they're literally controlled.
Islam have an interest rate.
It's not, it has nothing to do with
they're
Islam.
No, I'm
saying,
no.
They're controlling America right now.
Pay attention to
it's insanity.
The political power that Saudi Arabia has.
It's sad. It's actually crazy.
And keep in mind that they were the ones who
the evilest of all evil. Like, I'm not saying this because of anything, but, like, I honest to God that, like, they'll, like, annihilate journalists. Like, they don't give a fuck. They're literally that strong. They don't
they,
care.
They have, they don't there's give no a rules fuck. That they follow right now.
Literally, they took a guy into the embassy who was a journalist. They, like, pretended he had to get his paper. Like, literally, my dad told me the story. My dad's big into, like, international politics and, like, all this stuff, right? So he'll tell me these stories, and I'm just like, I listen and whatever, but, like, this one hit my, like, soul. I was like, holy fuck. This guy walks into the Saudi Arabia
You want me to tell the story?
Yeah, go ahead. Okay. But, like, no, I'm pretty, like, I have a good understanding of what happened.
I'm really
go
into
ahead.
Politics.
Yeah, no, go for it.
He was in, I believe it was Turkey.
Turkey, correct.
And he was an American journalist. He
literally.
Lived in America. He was a
New York
citizen of the States. Walked into
writer.
A Saudi Arabian embassy to fill out some paperwork because he was getting a divorce from his wife. Left his new wife outside waiting.
Can I
in the
interject
car.
When I know details that you may skip over? So, like, they told him to come. So he walked into the embassy one day, and they were like, "Oh, we don't have your papers ready, bro. Come back on this day."
Yeah.
Right. So, like, it was actually like a well thought out, premeditated thing. Like, he walked into the embassy to try to get these papers. They were like, "Oh, sorry, we don't have your file ready. Come back on this day," and then continue the story.
Oh yeah, and then anyway, he went in that day, and then he just has never been seen since. But somebody's walking out wearing his clothes, his exact clothes.
His clothes and somebody his and clothes. And all these like big boxes.
They chopped up his body.
They chopped up his body, and they had all these just giant boxes of like that shit that you throw bodies in that disintegrates.
In an embassy.
And they just walked out of it on camera. Like, on camera. And, like, they were, like, the entire international, like, spirit was, like, Trump, do something about this. Like, America, help.
You know how much power you have to have in the world to be able to do that in an embassy?
They fucking don't give a shit. And then the next day they had, like, cleaners, like, painters, like, everything. They redid the whole embassy. Then, like, that day. And it was just, like, the most obvious thing that's ever happened in the history of ever. And they were just, like, hey, guys, like, you care about human rights? Let's talk about it. Like, they were asking Trump. They were asking all these people, like, step in and do something. Like,
look at what he did. Look at what
they
Trump
have too much control
look,
and too much
look at
money.
What America just did to the Kurds over in Saudi or over
it's
in Syria.
Like, my dad literally gave me a bone-chilling story, and I was like, Dad, I can't know this.
Have you been paying attention to what's been happening over in Syria?
My brother's father's from Syria.
Bro, Trump pulled all the American troops out. In, like, 24, 48 hours.
Quick.
And in that amount of time, the Turks went in and slaughtered thousands of Kurds.
Thousands. Just, like, kids.
Kurds.
Women.
You know who the Kurds are, right? The Kurds were the number one force that took out ISIS.
That's fucked up.
They fought alongside us, taking out ISIS for 10
People
years. And the states just turned their back on them.
People don't look at the Middle
and,
East
wow.
for what's
Hold on.
Happening. They
in
see
the
it
process...
In, like,
the Turks bombed prisons that were holding ISIS prisoners,
mm-hmm.
allowing hundreds of ISIS prisoners to escape.
Wow, Turk knows his shit.
Because of Trump, ISIS has basically reformed. There's actually an ISIS flag flying again in a small city. That's some fucked up shit.
That's what people need to internationally That's know, and the up. News does not
Y'all
cover
Y'all gotta
it.
Pay attention to what the fuck's happening
but
in the world.
But the news does not cover it adequately or give you the information that you need to know. They give you, like, banners and, like, flashy lights and this, and, like, this
yep.
is what's But they don't give you the real information. You really have to dig deep to find that shit. That's not an easy thing. Like, I'm very, respect for knowing that shit.
Well, yeah, I pay attention to all that shit.
Like, big time. Like, how, like, I don't know a lot of, like, I don't want to say, like, you know, whatever, like, anything, like, a lot of people who are not of a minority, like, I'm not saying whatever, but, like, they just won't know that, right? It's, like, one of the, I'm not saying, like, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who you are, but.
I pay attention to everything that
But not everyone
the world.
Does.
I
not
know,
everyone does. Everyone just
what
eats
they
what
know.
They get from, like, ads
no,
or this
I,
or that or whatever.
I personally know from my. Education from my experience that whatever you're seeing on the TV is not what
False.
The story
Fake
is.
News.
There's always something behind that story, and yes, there's always
Hold
something
on, though.
Behind
and
that
here,
story.
And here's one thing that I learned just from having legal
silly.
Experts
it,
in the family.
Like, I'm, like, extreme.
You're telling me there's not always
But also,
something
you know more
like
than me.
From.
That's why I, like,
when it
teach
when it comes to
know.
Something that you see on the, this is why I hate the term fake news.
I didn't say that.
No.
Term.
No, but like, I can't stand it because if it's something that's presented on a public broadcasting system, it has to be true. Libel laws will not let that happen. Companies would be shut down instantly.
So what you are seeing, you're not seeing fake.
What you might see is what you see is bias.
Distorted.
A distorted reality.
That's my favorite word.
You see clips. You don't see the full truth, but you never see a lie. You just don't see the full truth.
You see a side and you see the facts, but the facts are strung together.
Pay attention to the distractions, though. What are the distractions right now?
I don't watch cable media.
Did I just tell you for the first time about the thousands of Kurds being slaughtered?
Yes.
Distractions, bro.
40,000 people.
No, but I'm just saying, like,
there was one bombing.
There's a lot of things that were being
one bombing one shown day right around now. Christmas time. One bombing one day, Syria. 400,000 people died in that day. Aleppo, Aleppo. I literally did not know about this country. I didn't know anything about it. But when I read that and it wasn't on the main, 400,000. We're not talking like 400 people.
That's a pretty high number. I don't think it was that many
people. No, that was the number. That was the number that like all of the actual, like, I don't know. It wasn't the news stations, but like some of the like.
Aleppo, that was the one that, that was the.
That was Christmas time.
That was the city that fucking, what's his name from the, that was running for president, didn't know where it was. They asked him on camera, they're like, what do you think about Aleppo? And he's like, what's Aleppo? And everyone was like, you're fucking dumb.
400,000 people, lives, souls off the earth. That's annihilation.
So they're definitely related to someone of significance. Or the relative to something of historical significance. Tell me I'm wrong.
Probably.
Nah, we're just greedy.
So there's relative to
money.
Historical significance?
Money.
Whoever has the most is not historically significant?
Only for the last couple hundred years. Think about your historical characters. The ones you actually pay attention to, most of them are impoverished.
Jesus was fucking rich, bro.
He was a carpenter, bro.
Have you seen how much a carpenter makes?
Back in the day when they built shit with sheep dung?
In cash. Most of the time.
You really think the carpenters were the rich ones in the villages back then, bro?
Maybe not the richest. The bankers obviously were.
Well, think about most of the significant like historical figures.
Gandhi?
Gandhi is internationally known as taking a vow of poverty.
Okay. Starvation.
And plus almost. He also slept with children, so we might not want to use him.
No, but
he
also...
He didn't like black people either.
No, he didn't.
He didn't.
Weird. He didn't.
He said that he agreed with some of Hitler's ideals, too.
What annihilating... Like,
side note, I think Hitler would be massively impressed with Brock Lesnar.
Brock Lesnar?
Yeah, what a fucking douche.
Yeah. What, you met him?
No.
Okay.
No, but...
I was just saying...
Somehow you gotta get your wrestling in there somehow. Jesus fucking Christ. Serious ass conversation and wrestling.
No, man, I'm telling you, but
it got real serious, man.
It did.
A bunch of times, like, whoa.
But
I like it.
No, seriously, and like every historical figure, if you read the textbooks from their native land, they're seen as like
heroes,
and you know what I mean, to be adulated. Wow.
Did you know that most of the writers that you listen or that you read nowadays died poor and desolate?
100%. Oh, wait. I have to jump in here for 2 seconds, I promise.
No, I figured.
Listen, there's this show that people do not know about called Billions, and it literally...
I've seen it. Is it any good?
Insanely good.
Okay.
But they were talking about... They were literally looking at this giant piece of art, like a Rembrandt or whatever, something amazing. And he's like, it's unfortunate that anyone that's made it that far had to be in the ground before they made it that far. And like they said it on that show, and I was just like, it's so true. And I think it's with ideas, with art of any kind, right? There's a lot of different art. And yeah, it just is what it is. Like, it is so true. Everyone watch that show.
What about Trudeau having that blackface?
did that.
Did he do that?
Because
that was fucked up. He really shouldn't have done that.
Well, clearly it didn't matter.
Right?
Well, it mattered enough.
I didn't vote for him.
I didn't vote for him. I vote for my own writing.
Why? I'm not looking at you. That's just the way that I'm sitting, bro. Here, I'll turn a little bit.
Y'all need to see that look. Y'all saw that look. Just give me that. But do you really think that, well, clearly they weren't, like, the world would be ready for a Jagmeet Singh?
No. Fuck no.
I'm not
disregarding his credentials or his credit, his capacity.
No.
Realistically?
Where I live, no.
Canada is, as a whole. Canada is an extremely liberal country. If you look at it, like, just break down the numbers. The votes when it comes to the left wing, like the Liberals, the NDP, Green, and like 75 fucking other little parties, that split so much. The right wing is split between two parties, and they can't win. Well, normally it's split between one party, and they didn't win. But now it's split
now
between two parties,
PPC?
And they can't win.
People's Party of Canada.
Now that we've split, like, I am fully, I'm so happy that there's now two right wing parties. Because now they just split the vote so much that we will be a left-wing country forever. Until they have to get that entire conservative vote to stop it. Mm. And now that conservative base is split, which is fucking amazing. But we are a completely left-wing country. The left-wing has a majority.
Our left-wing is like their very middle right or left-wing.
Even our conservatives here are basic. Would be considered left-wing.
Literal liberals. Like, yeah. Not liberals, what is it? Democrats and...
Like, they would be considered... Our right wing here would be considered Democrats.
Yeah,
in the
Republicans.
Big Democrats.
Democrats and Republicans.
They would be, like, nowhere near... Like, on a scale, so the, like, they say this is a scale, we'd be, like, here. In the middle of the, like, left quadrant. Like,
except for maybe the PPC. They're a little bit...
The PPC are very, extremely white.
Still a little bit. I mean, when you got Dave Rubin coming to events and shit.
I don't even know who he is, but I feel like my name is being sullied.
Bro, he used to be a huge liberal back in the day, and then he started getting funded by the Koch brothers and shit, and all these like conservative dark money.
So, what do you think about Adam Vancouverden, though?
But what?
Adam Vancouverden, Olympian turned politician.
I don't even know what the fuck you're talking about right now, bro.
Well, we're both on the same page.
All
right. We're both on the same page. But
Jesus, motherfucking Christ.
Candid conversations
was good tonight.
Yes, indeed. I'm not even sure if I'll be able to save this episode to my phone. I should be able to, but like...
Why? Because it's so long?
Yeah, after a certain time frame, it doesn't let me save it, so...
Okay.
That'll be uploaded, either way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That works. Why, are we done now?
Yeah, I think...
Alright, then.
I think we talked their ear off for a little bit. They probably tuned in. Like, I've seen some people tune in, like, multiple times. It's like, they're still talking. Jeez.
Yeah,
it's
so
okay. It's good.
We're talking so y'all tune in.
Exactly. Giving y'all time to tune in and hear what we're saying. And then, you know what I mean? I'm trying to see if we pick it up on what you want to hear about and, like, talking about it more. But either way.
Blah.
Exactly.
That's what's up.
So thank you for tuning in. You know what I mean? All of you who listened, all of you who watched before and after, was just saying, have a good night, y'all. Yes, you will, cuz. Thank you. Remember, drink those fluids. Drink those fluids and, yeah. Make sure you... Oh, shoot. Who's this?
Ooh.
Whoa. Drink those fluids. Supposed to have a cuz of... Like, friend. I didn't see him in there. But, yeah, bless up. We out.
Peace.
Oh, my gosh.
We're talking a lot. I'm exhausted right
now.
Like, just not having a backrest, guys. I'm not going to complain because I'm not that girl. But, like, it's actually a bit harder holding your posture together.
Yeah.
Right?
Your
like,
core
it's
is
your
like burning
my core
right now.
Is like, yeah.
Yeah.
Like, because I sat up, like, pretty relatively straight, like, just to make sure.
camera.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh, man. Okay. You do marketing and stuff like that, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, watch that screen on your, I guess, on your left now.
Right,
but you're going to have to. But hit the enter button on the keyboard.
Is this you?
Yeah.
I still have to put the titles in there.
Listening to this song now compared to what I do, like what I've been doing lately,
yeah,
sounds fucking like years old to me, like in my head.
Yeah.
The song seems ancient.
But it's only months.
I know.
It's only months, bro. All right.
Are we still live?
Look a little different.
Because I have my hair longer now.